The question is now, will they still be talking proud after a clash with the team of many tongues tonight? Different maps, same direction. Two upstart teams tangle this evening in Toronto. Good evening and welcome to Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC and to the Gardens in Toronto. I'm Ron McLean as we welcome an audience from Alberta to the Atlantic to see the Jets and the Leafs collide for the first time this season.
Wings, their Norris rivals. This was a battle for second spot in the division. The two teams at 75 points going in. There's Steve Chase on shot, redirected by John Ogrodnik. His second goal of the year made it 3-1 Wings in the second period. Dino Cicerelli then notches a pair. He's got 29 on the year. Steve Yzerman was the one with the beautiful pass on that play. Yzerman with four assists on the night. Detroit win.
Especially from the blue line. We think about Phil Housley. Waddy has 74 points coming into this game.
Well, you know, Bob, when you and I played, there was a rover. That's what Phil Housley is.
He's right behind us. Coming, eh?
Not here yet.
Last night, everybody asked me about last night. Pretty tough. I can hear Brian Murray say, listen, we lose this game with three games on hand. We're finished. They come out with a fire in their eye. They were hitting, they were banging. No way Detroit was losing that game last night.
And Toronto's missing three key regulars tonight, but one guy in uniform I know you like.
Well, the Bomber's back, and I'm glad to see him back. I don't know why he wasn't playing last night. They'll be going tonight. Listen, Toronto's going to win this game tonight, even though Barry's mad at me saying that.
There you see Ken Baumgartner, one of those he'll be trying to throw a little fright into is Tamu Solani. 56 goals, yes up, it's great.
Yes, it is great. Ty Domi even rooms with the guy, because when he rooms with the guy, he takes him around the streets, protects him too. Ty Domi, watch for number 7, there's Ty, watch for number 7 too. Hey, Chuck, what a guy, a Boston boy.
Of course, that's Tamu Solani. You know I'm in charge of the pictures when you're on in the opening. So you'll get your say in Coach's Corner, and after 40 minutes tonight, we'll deal with Doug Gilmore, so you'll want to tune into that, plus some thoughts about sports television coverage that you won't like, Don. Two Calder as the Leafs and Jets do so next.
After losing last night, it's a big game for them, and a big game for Bob Esenza and the Winnipeg Jets. Toronto born, Esenza goes for Winnipeg tonight. He's played in 54 games for the Jets. His latest win, a big one, 5-3 over Edmonton on Thursday. Now, there was speculation that Pat Burns would split last night and tonight with his two goalies, but he's elected to go again with Felix Potvin. His goals against remains the best in the league, 2.45. Denny Morrell is the referee for this one. Dan McCourt and Mark Bynes are the linesmen. Steen, Solani, and Shannon starting for Winnipeg. Randy Carlyle and Phil Housley, the defenseman, the first stop of the game by Potvin, and it's shot to the line. McIlwain, Pearson, and Clark. For the Maple Leafs, it's Clark with the puck, flipping it out over the line. On the far side was Pearson. Now from the Winnipeg blue line. Housley, body check, but he got the pass away. In on the wing, Shannon. He's covered. Back to the net and rouses his man trap. Here's Steen. Short side saved by Putman. Kept in along the boards, and the Leafs will come up with it and dump it down the ice. Very quick start for Winnipeg. Aker in there now. Carlisle tries to tie up his man, Ellett. Let a shot go way wide of the net. And it's cleared to the blue line and out. Kachuk, he tried a shot that's deflected over the glass and into the crowd.
Well, the Winnipeg Jets still bothered somewhat by injuries. They've had more than their share of them. They're dressing 7 defensemen tonight. Randy Carlyle is playing in his 22nd game of the season. And they go with 11 forwards, and this is the way they start as far as the lineup is concerned. Ron Paddick, the coach, has got Zamnoff, Newman, and Bouton, all key members of their team that are injured. Newman and especially to miss. Randy Carlyle, I mentioned, 499 career assists, so he needs one more helper to hit the 500 mark.
Crystal Nesky, Foligno, and Baumgartner, the Maple Leaf line. Borsato with Drews and Kachuk for Winnipeg. They remain on. The Leafs changed up. And this is Todd Gill leaving it for Crystal Nesky. Good move. Gets in the center. He's got the wheels going. What a rush by the veteran. He looked just like a rookie on that one.
Boy, I don't know whether I've seen Mike Krusilnicki show that kind of speed He's had a fine year. He nearly got his 20th goal on that rush. He blew by the forechecker at the Leaf blue line. He blew by the Jet defenseman at the Winnipeg blue line. But he couldn't blow it by Bob Esenza in goal for the Winnipeg Jets, who made a startling stop.
What a great rush. And here's where it started.
Now here's where he gets past the forechecker. And now he gets by the defenseman and cuts in. He can't quite get all the way across the net. And Esenza goes down and makes a big stop. I don't know whether Mike Krzyzewski was going to try to go across or just try to beat him. But Esenza outguessed him and makes the first big stop of this hockey game.
Boy, he had some room on that rush when he got in front.
And the rookie Keith Tkachuk hammers Mike Foligno, who was hunting for the rebound. Tkachuk, one of six rookies on the Winnipeg Jet lineup. Mike Krzyzewski nearly scored an early goal for the Leafs. And they need some instant success. They had their worst game of 1993, I thought, last night in Detroit.
Faceoff just outside the line, and Gilmore is on the ice now for Toronto. A slap from center ice, final save. Funny, huh? Got out front. Orzepski was on it quickly. Back to the line, and Jarvis for Lefebvre's shot. That hit a stick. Domi got in the way of that one. And it went wide. He keep it in. They keep the heat on Winnipeg now. Orzepski goes for the net. Look at Gilmore set it up. Right in front, and Richard was beaten by Bob Esenza. Two big scoring opportunities for the Maple Leafs early in this first period. There is no score yet. Winnipeg starting back out. They don't get too far. Lefebvre up to Gilmore. Orzepski with him. Drop to the line. Anderson blocked by Esenza. These are good chances by Toronto. Lefebvre. And that hit a stick in front. Orzepski without the helmet. Tried to pass it back out. And Domi takes it. Ty Domi slipped it up to Solani. He made a good play. It's in on the wing and centered by Ulanov. The defenseman was up there. There's a shot stopped by Potvin. Ulanov again. Sharp angle. Leafs clear it. All the way out and down the ice. And with Housley back, that's icing against the Maple Leafs.
Well, this game starts with a great pace. Doug Gilmore setting up Dave Anderchuk for the excellent opportunity for the Leafs. Gilmore gets all kinds of attention. He can't go very far in this league anymore without somebody in the other team after. And even Bob Esenza gets involved by trying to slow up Gilmore. Anderchuk got the best chance for the Leafs, and he could not put it by Bob Esenza, who made two in-close stops to preserve the zero on the scoreboard under the Toronto Maple Leaf logo.
McIlwain line again for Toronto. With Pearson and Clark. Stu Barnes for Winnipeg. Davidov and Chris King is the left winger, number 17. Davidov 11. Ellett number 4 for Toronto. Left it in the corner. Davidov comes up with it. Tries to skate to open ice. Back to the line with a shot. Deflected, but Potvin saw it and made the save. Here's Todd Gill with Ellett. Gill playing well for Toronto lately. Got the puck up over the line to center ice. Davidov turns it back. Made one good move and another. Got the zone, and then the shot went off the stick and over the glass.
Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs a little on the injured side of things now after having a fairly healthy season. Have dressed these six defensemen. Drake Barahowski played last night in Detroit after being recalled from St. John's. And Baumgartner is in the lineup. He was not in the lineup last night at Joe Louis Arena. The injured players for the Leafs, McCowan with a groin, Cullen with a neck, and Anderson out with a second stick violation, as Ron McLean mentioned in the open.
Ellett takes it back to the net. Stu Barnes standing in front of Potvin. Here's McIlwain, and he's a great skater, looking for open ice to move in. He can't find it. The Jets turn it back quickly. King comes over the line, drilled a hard shot, and he missed the net with it. Clark turns in front of his own goal. Clark wants to go. Gets to center ice. The pass hit Lawler. McIlwain hangs onto it. Hit Housley with it. He tried to shoot it in. Housley feeds it back up on the left wing. Barnes takes it over the Leafs line. That's broken up. No score. Nearing the 4-minute mark of the first period. 15 pass. Davidoff shot. He missed. He had Hutt pass back to the net, but he took that shot. Coming down the ice is Gill. Gill moves over the Winnipeg line. Flips it into the corner to the right side, and there's Dazzle, his first shift. Holding the puck on the board. Bird comes in to help, and he digs the puck out, but it came back to Salani. Now he can go. Shot! Oh, Potvin had a good stop with a blocker. That was labeled for the far side. Sharpshooter, this Salani. Found the opening. Shot misses. Off the boards for Berg. He's pushed into the board. Dazzle waits. Puck goes to the corner. Salani digs it out. Flips it to the right of the net. And then Steen centered it. Salani drilled it. Back block. Potvin sharp early. No score. Here's Dazzle coming in. Dazzle won't be given any room. Dean Kennedy was all over him. Kept him outside. Berg missed it. Osborne comes in to pick it up. He and Dazzle. Center! Shot by Berg. Dazzle back to the net. He had a great chance. Berg again. Winds up. Slips it through the crease. Kept in by the Maple Leafs defenseman Mironov. No score. Little over 5 minutes gone in the first period. And a great pace to start this game. Rouse back. The Leafs, as we mentioned, brought back down to earth by Detroit last night, having gone 10 undefeated. Winnipeg coming off a win in Edmonton on Thursday. Here's Borshevsky. Now Mironov. That's blocked. And it'll be cleared out by Tkachuk. He gets to the center and just rolled it into the Leaf zone. Nearing the 6 minute mark of the opening period. There's no score. Crowd appreciates the pace early in the game.
My staff is very good.
No getting around it. Service is definitely a hands-on business. That is my job, to provide that personal touch.
I think our customers appreciate the good service we give them.
At Esso, we're dedicated to getting you on your way with fast, friendly service.
Esso has standards, and I have standards.
And the Esso card with valuable Esso rewards gives our customers great service.
In my line of work, I appreciate certain things in the vehicles I drive, like performance and versatility.
93 Aerosport outperforms the competition with 4-speed overdrive transmission and more head and leg room.
Aerodynamic styling.
Our sports appearance package includes front-end spoiler, aluminum wheels, and Aerotech running boards.
Safety is a must.
Rear anti-lock brakes and driver's side airbag are standard.
And above all, great towing capacity.
93 Aerosport is your 40 Mercury dealer. Another reason we're winning the West.
Not magic. Just great value.
Play of Salani nearly scoring his 56th goal as he roars down the right wing and wires one that Felix Potvin had to be sharp. 11 goals in the last 5 games for the Jet rookie.
Quick shot from the faceoff.
Hendrick Chuck nearly scored for Toronto. Yes, he's done again. Sharp as is Potvin. In the early going of this game. Hunt pass slapped into the corner for Borshevsky. He comes down to Andrzejczyk at center. Andrzejczyk lifted one in as he was covered by two Jets. Borshevsky centered it. Housley didn't want to take any chances. He just turned and fired it down the ice. Coming back is Mironov, and that's icing called against Winnipeg. Had enough scoring chances in the early going to have maybe 3 or 4 goals.
That's been a great pace with some excellent opportunities for both teams. Here's a good chance for Andrzejczyk right off the draw. As the Winnipeg forward went to the wrong man, he has to stop at Andrzejczyk on the way out. He didn't, and it nearly cost them a goal. Andrzejczyk had a 7-game goal streak broken last night in Detroit. This is his 237th regular season game in a row. And he has 12 goals in 13 games as a Toronto Maple Leaf.
Shots are 5-4 in favor of Winnipeg. And I'll bet you each team could have had a pair, one anyway. Some great scoring chances early in the game. But there is no score yet. Kruszelniski, who had the first brilliant rush of the game, and was stopped by Bob Esposito, is on there now for Toronto. He's with Baumgartner, and he rolled it in. Wisniewski does not catch up with the doll. He's covered in the zone by Mike Lawler. Lawler on the board. Can't get it out. Back to the net to the other side. And here's Housley. Made a move to get away from Baumgartner. Slipped a pass to center. Tkachuk comes in. Passed it back. And there's a chance for Housley. Great save, Potvin! Housley was in and found the far side. But so did Potvin. Brilliant save.
I mentioned Phil Housley, very dangerous, coming late. Now watch this lovely little backhand pass. A lost art in this league, and then he joins the rush. He's out of the screen, but you're going to see him back here in a second. And as you mentioned, Bob, Potvin makes his best stop of the night on the clever Phil Housley. Here's what Potvin looked at. It's very hard to pick up the fourth man on the rush as he's trailing. Housley nearly got his 15th of the year.
A great glove save on that shot by Housley. Potvin sharp. Essen's a shark. And the pace great. We've got the makings of a beauty tonight. They played 7 minutes of the opening period. No score. Dave McElwain of the Maple Leafs. He has Clark, Kent Pearson, Barnes with Davidov and King. So anything could happen.
And the Leafs have to play an aggressive game against the Jets, but they ought to play it smartly. No unnecessary penalties.
Now, Keith Tkachuk comes out on the left side. That's the Winnipeg line. Stu Barnes remains in center. Pearson was a little anxious. So was Drake Barahowski, his first shift of the game. Now they're ready. I think. Crowd getting on the linesman.
Well, the linesman should make player Barnes put a stick down first.
They get it underway. Finally, Lafave ran into Tkachuk. And here's Barahowski. Comes to center and shot it from his own side of center. But Essen gets the whole ice in. Heavy hitting into the right of the net. Clark went in there and ran into Eakins. Lafave up the pass in back of the net, and Pearson is there. Has lots of time. Moved it out front, and the Jets were covering in front of Bob Essenza. Here's Davidoff fighting behind the play, and Clark is drilling the Winnipeg defenseman. It's Eakins. He had hit Eakins earlier. Hard hit. Eakins apparently must have come back looking for Clark, and he found him.
Eakins recalled from Moncton as free agent, signing by the Winnipeg Jets. He played in Moncton last year, and he took an awful wallop right here by Clark. And then two or three times after that hit, 55 Eakins and Clark tangled. And when they met after the puck left the Winnipeg zone, the skirmish started. And Clark, in about a second and a half, had Eakins down and pasted him a couple of times.
Penalty to number 52, Dallas Eakins, 5 minutes for fighting. Toronto penalty to number 17, Wendell Clark, 5 minutes for fighting. Time 7:33. Dallas Eakins, 5 minutes fighting. For Toronto, Wendell Clark, 5 minutes fighting. Time 7:33.
7:33, the time of the penalties, the first of the game, and they are majors. Clark of Toronto, Eakins of Winnipeg. No score, nearing the 8 minute mark now. First period is Ellis. Shoots the puck from center ice, coming back quickly. Darren Shannon can't get it out. Ellis gets the shot, but that's blocked. Now Zezel, he can't move in. Again, the Jets roll it across the line of center. Shannon, a stop there. Burke puts it into Zezel. Hit Heaven. Essenza, however, was out cutting the angle, and he did not give Zezel much room. Back in there for Salani. Look out! The backhander is stopped by Potvin. Well, what a great burst of speed by Teemu Salani. From the other side this time, down as the right winger, coming down the left boards now again, and took a hit from Gill. 8.5 minutes gone, first period. Still looking for the first goal. The Leafs dump it down the ice. Reaching his way off. Pushing and shoving behind the play. Turning a little physical. Berg is bumped at center. Lawler shot one from there. A weak shot. Puckman, no problem, decides he'd better go down on it. And the Jets, led by Keith Tkachuk, were in there quickly.
That's nice.
He's got goals, and he nearly scores the first one of this game. He scored in 9 of the last 10 periods, and 8 in a row till the second period Friday night in Edmonton.
And he's a rookie. Good. Lawler's shot. Hot pass, got that. Good play at center, 2-on-1. Borshevsky, Gilmore! Great save! Bob Essenza, Rob Gilmore. A brilliant 2-on-1 rush, a decent pass. Gilmore was in, but Essenza stopped him. Still no score, first period. Borshevsky after the puck. Here, back of the goal, Lawler there, trying to pick it up, but it's to the line. Shot in by Rouse, a weak shot. Essenza will pull it in. It's going to be a penalty. Essenza pulled it in and smothered it. And there's going to be a Winnipeg penalty on that play. We'll take a break. Find out about that other game we talked about. Here's Ron.
Okay, Bob, we're going to the Met Center in Bloomington. The Stars 6 points behind Toronto entering play tonight. They're hosting Montreal. The Canadiens draw first blood. That's Robert's to Jesse Bélanger. His first National Hockey League goal makes it 1-0 Montreal. But just minutes later, the Stars draw even. There's Mike Modano's shot. Dave Gagne pounces on the loose puck, beats Patrick Roy, and it's 1-1 in Minnesota.
Minnesota better watch it. St. Louis lost today. Look at this great 2-on-1.
Essenza makes a similar stop to two-pad sprawl as the one he made on Churchill Nesson. Here's the penalty to Phil Housley for knocking Doug Gilmore down in front of the net. Rare spot for Housley in the penalty box.
The cross-checking penalty. The Leafs, a power play. No score. First period. Leafs pass it around on the outside. Jets are happy with that. Very content to see him move it around, but here's Gill with a shot. That goes to the boards. Ellis to Gill again. Now Gill winds up. Took a shot block, and it was cleared out to center ice. Fine play by Borsato. John Bruce back fast. Got it by Ellis at the blue line. The Leafs have to skate back on try. Drilled back in by Gill. 1:20 left in the power play. No score. Ellis coming up. Shot into the crowd. It goes as it was deflected by Kennedy.
Well, Gilmore's a marked man. When you get 100 points, you are going to be a target for every one of the opposing defenders. And Dean Kennedy is no exception as he runs Doug Gilmore into the glass after Gilmore pushed the puck further into the Jets zone. The Leafs, in their loss last night, did not break the record for consecutive games on a loss. That's Bill Borosko's sweater. He was a member of the 1950-51 team that has the team record, 11 without a loss.
Stanley Cup winning goal.
I was there, Foley, you know that? 10 years old, in Blues.
Come a long way.
He was a great player, Bill Borosko.
Ellis and Borshevsky get the puck over the line. Borshevsky can't get a shot, though. Carlisle had him lined up. And the Jets will send the Leafs back again. 50 seconds left in the penalty. Housley in the penalty box. No score. Leafs move up again. Ellis takes it to center. Fire the pass in. It could be icing. It is. Off the boards to the Winnipeg player. An icing called against Toronto.
Well, John Paddock, the Winnipeg coach, has done a real fine job of coaching these Jets. He's had an inordinate number of injuries to key players. Olofsson was out a long time. Newman is still out. Boughton was out for a while. Zamnoff and Druce. A lot of broken bones and bad backs. And Paddock has managed to keep this team together and fairly well focused. And should they get healthy, which they ought to, according to him, in a couple of weeks, they may cause some trouble in the playoffs.
Talked to him this morning, and he missed breathing a sigh of relief, winning on Thursday in Edmonton. Instead of 6 points ahead of Edmonton, they now have a 10-point spread on the Edmonton Oilers. That last playoff spot in the Smythe. The Leafs power play. 25 seconds left on it. Krzelnicki has the puck. And he waits at the board. Steps in. Passes off. Gets in front. Pass came back by everybody all the way back to Plattbank. 10 seconds left in the Winnipeg penalty. Housley ready to come out. As Mironov gets to center and ripped it in. Hitting the boards, and it goes around the net to the other side. The Jets will bring it out. Housley is on the ice, and on this rush, he gets the pass. Housley's shot. Cut by the save. It's knocked away by Mironov, as the rebound was there in front for a split second. Now Krzelnicki. He's shot. Off the stick of Carlisle, nearly fooled Essensa, who's 15 feet out of the net. 8 minutes, 5 seconds left in the opening period. No score. The teams are at full strength. As the Jets start back out to center ice. The pass by Ulanov to the left side. And taking over is Lefebvre. Can't move it out on the first try. So he leaves it for Zezel. Zezel comes back up. Long shot in. Trying to lead it in for Osborne. He was in the center. Zezel to he scores! Zezel!
Shoulder of Bob Essensa after taking a nice pass out from Mark Osborne. Leafs go up 1-0 with 7:37 to go in the first period. Zezel's been a long time between points.
Goal scored by number 25, Peter Zezel. Assist number 21, Mark Osborne. Time 12:23. Peter Zezel from Mark Osborne. Time 12:23.
12:23, and no question. Zezel and Osborne. Full responsibility for that scoring play by the Maple Leafs. Here's Gilmore centering one. Everybody was in deep. And the Jets get it out. Now it's Olsson. Starting to the blue line at center. He shot a long one in wide of the net. Gill has it. Gill being watched by Stu Barnes. Here's Davidov. His shot hit a skate. Bounces to center ice. Olsson was heading off, changed his mind when he saw that puck. Now Gilmore has a chance to wind up, and he dropped it back instead of going on, so Gill brings it up to center ice. Here's Borshevsky, and he can go. Borshevsky in! Nice save by Essensa. Gallant backs up as Davidov comes to center. He dropped it to Barnes. Barnes is over the line, and the pass to the blue line of Lawler, and his shot wide of the net. He's cleared again, and this pace continues to be a quick one. 6:30 remaining in the first period. 1-0 Toronto on the Zezel goal. Puck cleared out by Tkachuk in the center. Here's Housley, and he shoots it. He's hit immediately by Pearson. Lefebvre takes it back to the goal. He starts out a long pass to Pearson, a wicked pass, and he couldn't stop it. So that's another icing call against the Toronto Maple Leafs. Zezel from Osborne. And it's 1-0 Toronto.
What a great finish. What a great week. And tremendous curling. By the lady curlers of our country today. So we'll be well represented at the World in Geneva. Of course, Harry and I were just talking a little while ago. Can't believe the playoffs are getting so close.
5 weeks away.
And we're talking hockey, of course, now. That was the curling plug, Harry.
I know you love that sport.
Here's Pearson.
And he overskates the puck for the Leafs. Keep it inside the line. The pass, however, hit a skate. Clark was in front of the net alone. Orsato threw it into the Maple Leaf zone. 5:25. Left in the opening period, 1-0 Toronto. Lefebvre leads this rush from center ice. It was deflected and just wide, but offside at the blue line anyway. So it would have been called back.
coming up in our first intermission. Of course, Don Cherry is in the Coach's Corner. And don't forget our hometown heroes tonight from Red Deer. Some famous people from Red Deer.
And a very good... Wait, stop that, Dave.
No. Oh, you can't
hide
anymore.
Oh, delay.
And we thought he was perfect. McLean from Red Deer. Hey, Grape.
You like that? You like that, Don?
We've got to tell you, he didn't know the first thing about it.
He thought he'd burnt that tape.
He got the extra copy. I'm not saying anything. The fear of the big one out is you or me, Harry. Play call. There's going to be a Leaf penalty. 5:07 left in the period. And the Leafs are leading 1-0, and Mironov is going off.
Mironov gets a holding penalty, and the Jets get their first power play opportunity of tonight's game. They have 75 power play goals.
Time 14:53.
Look at the top of the frame there. You can see right there as he holds up Ty Domi, who's going in to try and recover a loose puck behind the Leaf net.
Here's Mironov in the penalty box, and now the Jets with a man advantage and a chance to tie it. Steen, Stellani, Tkachuk, they're up front. Housley, of course, is on the ice, and here's Olofsson to Housley. Whipped it in for Steen. Back to the line. Olofsson. Tkachuk rolled it back in front. It comes to the blue line. Olofsson again. Shot deflected wide. Tkachuk to Steen. Steen waits at the rim of the circle. Stepping in. High shot off Putman and the glass. The Leafs can't find it, though. Stellani played it ahead. Tkachuk played it back. And the pass came over the line. Housley miscued, and it came out over the line. That's Osborne in for checking Housley. 1:25 left in the penalty to the Maple Leafs. Mironov. The Leafs are leading 1-0. Winnipeg on a power play, and it can't keep it in. We're offside. If he catches it, he does not. Allowing the Leafs to kill a few more seconds by shooting it down. That was Bob Rout. And it also allows the Leafs to change the penalty killers. A minute left in this power play for Winnipeg. And it can't get it going. Shot in by the Maple Leafs again. And Berg moves up. Berg all over Housley. Berg took the puck away from him. And now Housley takes it again. Back to the net. Housley brings it out. Fake the pass. Got away from Krushelinski. A rather dangerous move, though. He was in there alone. Ellen left it in the corner. The Jets will pass it around. In back to the net. Shannon tried to center it. It's Krushelinski. Didn't get it out, but Berg does. 20 seconds left in the penalty. 1-0 Toronto. It is Shannon moving up over the Leaf line, and he dumped it in back to the net. Potman was out to stop it. Comes all the way back to Olofsson. Housley couldn't knock it down, and the Leafs can't get it out. Now it's Gilmore. He lost a chance to move it out. Olofsson gets the shot. Potman the save. The penalty is over. Mironov on the ice, and the Leafs on the puck. And they clear it a little too high. Came off the stick of Gill. Went over the glass into the crowd. 2:57 left in the first period. And Harry Neal in the gondola at Maple Leaf Gardens. Don Cherry, Ron McLean along with us. And they'll be on in 2:57 from now in our first intermission. Coach's Corner, Ron and Don. Here it's 1-0, the Maple Leafs. Goal by Zezel, set up by Osborne. And again, the puck is souvenir on this Saturday night.
Well, the Winnipeg Jets have got their hitting line out there. King Eagles and Ty Domi. Remember, Ty Domi was drafted by the Leafs and then traded to New York. And then on from New York on to Winnipeg in the Ed Olczyk deal. He and King have given the Winnipeg Jets their real dimension in physical play that they didn't have before these two fellas arrived. And Ty Domi, usually. major league makes his presence felt most nights.
He sure did in the Big Apple and was very, very popular in his days with the New York Rangers. Quite popular now in Winnipeg, thank you. Jets trying to move into third place in the Smythe Division. A point ahead of L.A. They can win this one tonight. 2:35 left in the first period. Right now, they trail the Maple Leafs 1-0. And Gilmore comes in. Turns back. And a quick shot. Rebound! Two big saves by Issa. Andrew Chuck broke in on him. Got the first shot away, grabbed the rebound, and put that one on the net. Stopped them both. Domi giving a bump by Gilmore. Gilmore fell on the puck. The referee standing right there. Signs to the big dot to the left of Potvin. No penalty, but a faceoff coming up in the lead zone. We have another update. Ron.
Thank you, Bob. We go to the Civic Center in Hartford, the Vancouver Canucks and the Whalers. It's the Whalers at home drawing first blood. Here's Yvonne Corriveau. He'll get it to Michael Nylander, and he scores his fifth on the year as he beats Kirk McLean. The Whalers are on a roll coming off a win in Buffalo. They lead Vancouver 1-0 in the second at Hartford.
Bob Essens has been sharp in the goal for the Winnipeg Jets. He makes that first and then grabs the rebound off Dave Anderchuk. Anderchuk's a tough guy to handle going to the net.
Only one goal in the game so far. That by Peter Zessel from Mark Osborne. For Osborne, his 300th career assist. 2 minutes, 5 seconds left. First period. Puck comes to center ice as Kennedy had missed it, standing at the lead blue line. That is Borsato trying to bring it in the slot area. Back to Kennedy. He faked the shot, had Baumgartner fall, and Baumgartner gets up to get the puck. Put it back to the line, and it got out, back in again, so that's offside at the Maple Leaf blue line. We have 1:45 left.
The Leafs are playing their third game in four nights. And Pat Burns was saying that he'd be very surprised if after the worst game he's seen his team play in a long time, that they didn't come up with a pretty good one tonight. And they have played a lot better tonight here in the first period than they played at any time last night in Detroit. After tonight, for the next six games, the Leafs play are on the road. Winnipeg Jets travel down the Queen Elizabeth Highway to Buffalo for a Sunday night game in the auditorium tomorrow.
And with that Red win last night, they have a 2-point spread on Toronto now. Not much of a spread, is it? Detroit tied with the Leafs going into the game. Penalty coming up against Winnipeg. Now I have a 2-point lead.
Boy, Dean Kennedy, Bob, threw the best body check in a long time at Maple Leaf Gardens. And Kem Baumgartner, who usually delivers them, doesn't take them, took one along the boards. It was a perfect check. There's a penalty called on the play, but I don't know who it is. Baumgartner's waiting for the slow puck to come around the boards. And Kennedy meets him before Baumgartner was ready. Two Western Canadian boys collide heavily, and Kennedy gets the penalty on it, perhaps for elbowing, maybe for charging. Baumgartner gets about 210 pounds right in the jaw.
I think you're right on the second one, probably charging.
Kennedy, 2 minutes for charging.
Yes.
Time 18:32.
At 18:32.
For charging.
Well, you know, if you're a coach, you will be a lot less unhappy about a penalty like that than you will for ones that are hooks and holds in the offensive zone or retaliatory penalties. I'm sure John Paddock would like to see a little bit more of that. Tampa Bay giving it to Calgary in Florida. They have been tough to beat. They beat the Montreal Canadiens last week there. Reese is in after Vernon started. We're having a conversation here about where the faceoff should be. Winnipeg is lobbying to get it outside the zone, and the Leafs are saying it should be inside. The Jets win the argument. The Leafs are on the power play.
And it's their second of the night. The goal they had scored was even strength. So then they're 0-for-1. Morrell now is trying to get everybody organized and move the Jets.
Paddock made a late line change. He tried to get number 15, John Drews, out there after that long delay. And Denny Morrell, the referee, wouldn't go along with it.
So Borzato is back out with 1:28 left. First period. Borzato won the draw, kicked it back, and it's cleared the length of the ice. Toronto 1, Winnipeg no score. Leafs power play, led by Gill. The center, where he shoots it in. Hustling back is Ulanov. He put it high on the glass, and Gill will stop that. Ellett now. A pass into the side of the net. Gilmore drifts back out with it. Gilmore put a pass in. It is centered. Gilmore can't catch up to it. We're in the final minute of the first period. Orshevsky in on the board. Gilmore back to Ellett. Ellett gets set. No shot. Gilmore might shoot it. No, he comes in. And his pass goes in back of the goal. Orshevsky to Gilmore again. Gilmore gets ready. Ellett from the blue line. Over to Gill. Nobody wants to shoot. Ellett to Gilmore. Ellett again. Gilmore waits for it off the glass. As Gill took the shot and it bounced over its stick. 24 seconds left in the period. It's Ulanov for Winnipeg. Got it by Ellett and down the ice it goes. 15 seconds remaining in the period. Ellett very quickly to center. Lifts one in. Ice stick made contact. The Leafs went in offside anyway, and they'll bring it back out with only 8 seconds and a bit left in this first period.
Dave Ellett, a former Winnipeg Jet, he's 10th in the all-time scoring for the Winnipeg Jets with 299 points. And last night, he got his 300th career assist. Todd Gill made a nifty little move to take the puck off the boards. Now, he plays on the right side. Watch this. He wouldn't have tried that last year in a... on a bet. Gloria Salming could do that as well as any player I'd seen. Take it on the backhand and get it to the middle.
Long shot from center ice by Borzato. Deflected away by Potvin. And a horn goes to end. Period number one coming up in the coach's corner is Don Cherry. The shot 12-10 in favor of Toronto. The score at the end of the first period. Toronto 1, Winnipeg no score.
There are differing opinions on what it means to be Canadian. But the classic definition is as follows. To be Canadian, you must be clean, cold, and crisp. Because this is what beer's all about.
Okay, now pay attention. This button plays the message. Don't touch it, you'll break it.
Sooner or later, answering machines break.
This button erases the message. Don't touch it, you'll break it.
But with Sastel's Message Manager, you don't have to worry about broken tapes or garbled messages.
Okay. Now this button, hey, it's broke. Did you touch it? I told you not to touch it.
I didn't touch it.
Well, it's broke.
You broke it.
Sastel's Message Manager, the better answer to the answering machine. Call us today.
Take a moment to compare the 93 Ford Taurus GL sedan and wagon to the imports. Taurus comes well equipped with over 24 standard features including air, power windows, and available anti-lock brakes. You'll also discover not just one, but two airbags. The price? Thousands less than the imports. Wagon or sedan, just $19,995. No wonder Taurus is the best-selling car in North America.
Quality is job one. It's working.
One small candle. When it's cold outside, it'll warm you for hours. At Esso, looking out for your safety is part of our service. So remember, a candle is one of the essentials you should have in a winter emergency. Be ready for road emergencies with the St. John Ambulance Family Safety Kit. Call 1-800-463-ESSO to order on your Esso card. It may even save your life.
You're on your way.
Okay, guy, let me give you a tip. Spoon.
Joey, I hear you want to marry my daughter.
Well, actually, yeah. See this bone, Chunky?
It's loaded with tender meatballs and pasta.
You need it with a fork
or with a spoon?
Eat it with a fork.
I use a spoon! But I respect a man with a mind of his own. Welcome to the family.
with Don Cherry is brought to you by Pepsi. Gotta have it.
Good question.
I think some people today finally realize that these are the serious 90s. Kids today have come to accept that this is a time for introspection, moderation. You can just witness the new emphasis on discipline everywhere you look. That's the way it is. Isn't it? I'm not making this up. Listen, a lot of research went into this.
Told you looked better on me, Bruce, old boy.
Bruce McGall, owner of the Los Angeles Kings, gave you that tie last week in the second Coach's Corner during the Toronto-LA telecast. Don, there was talk this week from the Canadian Association of Broadcasters of changing television coverage of hockey, at least.
Who are these
came
guys?
Out that they would turn away from...
Who are these guys?
Private broadcasters... group put together to try and provide a code of ethics with regard to
violence. This is a funny thing. It's not, we're socialists. We're not quite communist yet. They're going to tell us what we can watch and what we can't watch.
No, they won't go for that.
No, okay. They won't. Well, they're going to...
It was talked about.
All right. Here's the funny thing. In the Toronto Star the other day, they had it front page. They had, fans react. Broadcasters, and they had Ken McKee, number one guy, not only the front page, but the back page, right? And we're having a telephone, Paul, had to see about this violence. So the poll comes in, we find out we have...
should there be fights on TV?
Should there be fights on TV, right. Who's telling this story?
Well, just...
anyhow, they have a poll, and it comes out 80%, 3,000, 7,000 good people phoned in and said, yes, we should see the fight. And 800 jerks phoned in and said we shouldn't.
No, I can't.
So now, what do you think they did? Did they have Ken McKee do a big column again? Did they have a write-up on it? No. Here's what they had, folks, in the corner. That's what they had.
All right.
Now, you can bet your you know what.
I tried to phone you all day. You were
wait
busy.
A minute.
We're really tight.
Just a
time.
Minute, I know. But you can bet one thing. If it was the other way around, Ken McKee and them would have had it like that. Fans react. Absolutely ridiculous. Little thing like that. That's what you have to watch, what we got going in the media.
80% said they'd like fights, and they're getting it. Miss installment of the Coach's Corner.
Yeah.
Do you like Mighty Ducks as a name?
Mighty Ducks is all right. So what? Doesn't bother me. I don't know. What are they going to put? What's Penguins? What do you like? Penguins? Penguins are stupid, too. So all right, and they're doing all right, aren't they? Mighty Ducks.
I like it too. Danny Good. Gallivan, a beautiful service was held.
Boy, I got to hurry on this one, folks. I'm telling you, Danny Gallivan was the only time he was ever reprimanded was to be on with me. We were doing a game for Channel 11, and at the end of the period, he said, Don, what do you think of that period, Don? I said, that's the worst period of hockey I ever saw, Dan. I said, the only star here is the Zamboni driver. Some of you guys remember that. Anyhow, he says, yes, Mr. Cherry, that is like a hobo's coat, shabby. And we've got it coming up. When you see the hair on me, folks, I'll tell you, pretty nice. But anyhow, I love this guy. Everybody loves him. Mark and Jim, let's run this to a great guy.
From your grapevine.
Right.
I want to tell you how delighted I am to be in the presence of an international television celebrity such as you.
I told you he was great. He knows great talent, too.
How did you get started in the broadcasting?
Well, it was in Antigonish when I finished university in 42 with a B.A., and with a B.A., you can't make a living with a B.A. You've got to have something.
That's tough on me with public school.
Well, the thing is, but the thing is, with your personality...
That's true. My wardrobe.
I mean, you can't get that type of personality in college.
That's true.
You were born with it.
That's right.
Should be very grateful.
You either have it or you don't.
And you've got it in copious quantities. But let's get back.
What is that, a disease?
Okay, you mentioned Selke's name. Three or four questions ago, and I don't think I answered as I should have. He was a great help to me in the beginning. I remember my first game in the fall of 52 going up to his office and saying to him, well, here I am starting out, any words of advice? And he was so admired in those days, still is. And one would be fearful going close to him, or even to his office, that inner sanctum. But I got up the nerve and I went in. I said, look, words of advice, I'm starting tonight. He said, look, young man, he said, I want the Montreal Canadiens to win every game they play by 10 or 15 goals. Don't make any mistake about that. But he said, you remember, you're a broadcaster. There's another team on the ice. That stood me in good stead.
Where did you get the phrases, cannonading? Is that how you say it, cannonading?
No, I did that. Bobby Hull came up in the 50s. You know, everybody today, practically everybody, can shoot the puck as hard as Bobby Hull could in the 50s. But Bobby was rare when he blasted that great guy coming up in the left wing. What a sight.
Yeah, it was.
I got carried away one night, and I was thinking of a shot, just like coming out of a cannon. And I got letters, three or four letters, from people versed in English. And they said, there's no such a word. So as soon as I knew that they were critical, I kept using
it. They were listening to you. What's the other one? Stintillating or? How's that called?
Oh, scintillating.
Oh, scintillating. Oh, I knew it was something like that.
Yeah.
I know I get in trouble all the time. Now that way they fire me all the time.
I did that in a Quebec playoff game working with Dornhofer one night. And I said the Bouchard made a scintillating save. And then we had the replay. The puck wasn't even on the net.
You remember my game in Montreal Farm?
Oh yeah, 1954.
That's right.
Well, you know, if you were going to play one game in the National Hockey League, you might as well play it in the Shrine.
Yeah, I took a regular shift, too.
Yeah, and was Beliveau out on the ice when you...
Beliveau was on the ice. My claim to fame, the National Hockey League got a penalty against him. That's it. That's my career. Not bad. But I got famous later.
Well, indeed you did. You played in Three Rivers.
Oh. Danny, let me tell you something. I got to shake your hand. Of all the shows, this is the truth. I wish that this show had been 3 hours long. I could have gone on. I love this guy. I'm telling you, let's give him another hand. I love him.
Coach's Corner with Don Cherry is brought to you by Pepsi. Gotta have it.
Beautiful Red Deer, located in central Alberta, equidistant between Edmonton and Calgary. Just over 56,000 citizens proudly involve themselves in sports year-round in this community known for oil and agriculture. For many years, the Red Deer Arena housed hockey memories. Today, the Western Junior Rebels reside at the Grandiose Centrium. They're in their first season in the league and are coached in part by Mike Moeller, a former National Hockey Leaguer who looks so sharp behind the bench. Mike, of course, played alongside his brother Randy with junior teams in Red Deer. There he is with the Moose Chiefs, the Bantam squad. They went on to play for the Red Deer Rustlers. In fact, in 1980, captured the Centennial Cup along with three of the Sutters, Rich, Ron, and Brent. The family contributions from Red Deer also include the Wesleys, Glenn, and his older brother, Blake. North Star defender Mark Tenorti set the standard for excellence at an early age with several local champs. There's his Wall of Fame. And here's the one that belongs to Bill Sr. and Bill Jr., the Ranfords, another proud Red Deer family. All who, like me, have been lucky enough to live in Red Deer, Alberta, know of it as a great hockey community. Tonight, it's on Ford's Hometown Heroes, brought to you by Ford of Canada.
Slapping at it is Lawler, and he's successful in clearing it off the boards down the ice, where Todd Gill takes it behind the net. 7 seconds left in the penalty, and the Leafs get it up to Borshevsky, and it hopped away from him. Now Kennedy is back out of the penalty box. Having served that minor penalty, Lawler is in with a shot that's deflected high into the crowd.
This portion of Molson Hockey Night in Canada on
Hartford Castle. Goals as they are leading Vancouver. Minnesota could do the Leafs, or Montreal could do the Leafs a favor. Minnesota's beating them. Boston, as we know, won in overtime this afternoon on a Bork goal. Quebec is pounding the Rangers in Quebec City. Back it with 4 points. Tampa Bay has got Calgary by the throat in court. This one. ...12:23 of the first period. Mark Osborne set him up for his 300th career assist. Zazzle against Steen. Inside the Leaf line. Rouse takes it. Behind the net and waits for Zazzle to come back. goes by Zezel the other way. Now Zezel knocked down the pass at center, and he comes in. Zezel dropped into the line. Burke's shot is blocked by Carlisle, and then it went high into the glove of Bob Esenson.
Randy Carlisle, the legs have gone, but the head's still there, so he doesn't take too many unnecessary steps. And of course, he played for the Leafs in 77-78. And this is the way he looks now. He's had a long and very distinguished career with one Norris Trophy stuck in there at one time. Carlisle, number 8, comes over and deflects the shot up. So it's an easy one for Bob Esenson to have.
McIlwain for Toronto. Hart and Pearson. Borsato for Winnipeg. Bruce and Tkachuk. Long shot in there. Blocked in front of Esenza. And it's poked to center ice. Shot in by Bruce. Tkachuk moving along the boards, but it goes away from him. Back to the net for Rouse. He tried to hit Pearson. Missed him. And it, Tyson called against the Maple Leafs.
Well, Phil Housley, we talked about him in the opening. He is has a great offensive imagination. He gets himself into trouble defensively in the five-on-five situations because he's not very big and has a tough time handling opposing forwards. Although he's the leading point-getting defenseman in the National League, he's a minus 19. At the same moment. So that is about the only blur on his statistical information for this 92-93 season.
Played up front for some time with Buffalo. But it's solid now back on defense for Winnipeg. Olofsson didn't shoot. Saddle. Set it right under the stick of Pearson. He starts Clark out with McIlwain. McIlwain trying to rush in. He'll get there at the far side. Push it to the corner to Clark. Here's Pearson behind the net. His pass to the blue line. And it was cleared. Tkachuk spinning away from McIlwain. Gets it over the leaf line and backhands it around the net. Puttbank coming out to clear it up to Pearson. Pearson bumped. Olofsson kept it in. Marinov will take over, but he's going to be checked. However, it's Clark for Toronto. High pass intended for Pearson is knocked down with that high stick of Olofsson, and the play is stopped.
Well, Frederick Olofsson, had he not knocked that one down, Pearson may have been able to walk in alone on Esenza. 8 of his 11 goals have been on the power play this year. He has 21 assists, so 29 of his 39 points have come with the man advantage. 25 points in the Winnipeg Arena, 14 on the road. Frederick has only played 49 games, and he's sadly missed when he's not in the lineup for the Winnipeg Jets.
Again, Toronto comes out with Kuchelnitsky, Foligno on the right side, Baumgartner on the left. Barnes at center ice for Winnipeg. King and Davidoff. That's Ulanov trying to shoot it out. It goes around the net to the other side. Parika. He just sidestepped a hit coming from Baumgartner. Here's Berehowski for Toronto. Up to center ice and shoots one to the corner to the right of Esenza. He's out of the net. Foligno is checked. Berehowski's shot and he missed by 4 feet. Davidoff. Coming to center for the Jets. Gets to the leaf line and tries to do it himself. King passes back. And here's Ulanov's weak shot. And Foligno will try to clear it. It got out over the line. Off the couple of sticks. Jets shoot it back in. Hotman will stop it. Lefebvre quickly to Foligno. He was slow moving on it. Lefebvre again. King missed it. And it's Foligno pushing ahead, but it's slapped back in by Ulanov. Nearing the four-minute mark, second period, 1-0 Toronto. Kuchelnitsky shooting one in. Relief defense changes. Brawler back there fell, got back up in time to move it. And Tkachuk tried to sweep it toward the net. Borshevsky is in there, knocked it loose. And at the far side, it's cleared back out by Solani. Back in again. and the tuck. In front, the shot goes empty again. Down on the goal tree. And a step down. Yep, get it up to center. Eliel up to shove it back in. Essence is covering. Hooks it up on the board. There's Berg. Moving in is Gilmore back of the net. Gilmore shaking off a hit. Gilmore centered it. Berg is tied up by Lawler and the goaltender after the hang on.
Dave Anderchuk got another opportunity. He didn't get a lot of wood on it. He had six shots on goal in the first period, and three of them were excellent scoring opportunities. Bob Essenza has been sharp in the Winnipeg net tonight, keeping the Jets alive. And here from over Essenza's head, we can see the least chances here. Housley goes down and makes the shot block on Borshevsky. Borshevsky recovers the puck. Anderchuk can't get it on his stick as he walks out from behind the net. Former Leaf Kevin McGuire watching the game. He's now trying to launch a career as a referee. We all know Paul Stewart, who played a lot like Kevin, has turned into a very competent referee in the National League. Here's hoping we'll see Kevin McGuire someday.
Toronto 1, Winnipeg, no score. And they're coming up to the 5-minute mark. Second period, the shot comes in from an angle. McCann reaching out, he's steered away. And the Leafs bring it back out. Up to center and going in is McElwain. He can't get by Kennedy. And the Jets shoot it down the end. Rouse will pick it up before it hits the red line. And he's like the Chuck. Pearson must have been the icing call. And Kennedy can get there before McElwain. Barely. Icing called against Toronto. It is 1-0 Maple Leafs, and we'll return to Maple Leaf Gardens.
Beside Steve Stavro watching the game, and that's the son of goal judge, Dave Jr., at the north end of the gardens.
Keon, of course, former captain for the Maple Leafs, winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy. It's a big year of the Sawchuk game to play for the Maple Leafs. He played well. Toronto leads this hockey game 1-0. They've hit the 5-minute mark of the second. Winnipeg on the move. King is in front of the net. Domi tried to circle and jam it in the far side. Lefebvre. Domi in there hitting. He ran into Lefebvre as he cleared it. Ulanov shot it on the board to center. The Leafs are on the puck. And it's Gilmore inside the line with Borshevsky, close quarters. Barahowski was standing there with him, but he had to back up. And Lefebvre slapped it hard back in. Dallas Eakin with Ulanov. Ulanov's pass is knocked down. High stick. Play stop. And we'll be back after this. Only goal of the game in the first period. 12-23. His 10th of the season. 1-0 Toronto. We're nearing the 6-minute mark of the second period. This is Mike Lawler with a puck for Winnipeg and starting out. Dropped it back. Housley didn't expect that. But he made a pretty good move on Berg to get it up off the board. Shannon slapped it toward the Leaf net. Bill got back against Solani. Dessel scooped it along the board. Berg there, can't move it out. Winnipeg keeps the pressure on, but it's off the stick of steam. And Lawler has to back up. Osborne chasing him all the way. The pass to an open wing. Shannon won't catch up to it. Todd Gill. He's back deep in his own zone. Now Ellis. He finds Osborne. Osborne from center shoots it in. Berg is moving up along the board. Lonnie slapped it back deep in his own zone. Now he takes the pass to center. Talani moving up over the line, but the Leafs are back to break it up, and Gilmore was there. Osborne off the board to Spank, intended for Berg. It didn't work. And the Jets bring it back in. Barnes drops it toward the net. Hill was standing in front of the net. Todd Gill, right wing pass to Gilmore, too far, but he caught up to it. Gilmore coming in, drops it back, and then Osborne, or Krushelnicki, as it was tipped away from him. Jets go offside, but the play will continue as they get back outside the blue line. It is Gilmore again. Up for Foligno. That does not work. Jet checking more closely now. Only one goal in the game. Very fast moving first period. Pace slowed a little bit here in the second. Long pass, 10 for Gilmore, but he's offside. Close call, nearly hit a Winnipeg stick. Gilmore's offside.
Well, a game of some interest to the Leafs occurring in Minnesota, 2-1 Minnesota. Patrick Roy has been hurt, a hip flexor injury. Andre Rossico is now in goal. And that's bad news for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Cheering for Montreal tonight, I'm sure. There's Lawler, he's getting his right skate sharpened. See, he's one of the many players in the National League that do not wear socks.
Going into this game tonight, as you mentioned, the Canadiens and Roy injured. We'll try to bring you up to date on that injury, the extent of it. The Canadiens first overall with 88 points. Pittsburgh, 84. And the Penguins have been having a tough time lately. We're nearing the 8-minute mark of the second period here at Maple Leaf Gardens. Bob Cole with Harry Neal in the gondola. Tom McLean and Don Cherry, the Hockey Night in Canada crew. And the Leafs are after the puck in the Winnipeg zone. Pearson takes it back of the net. He comes out with the pass, but McIlwain was tied up in the crease. Tkachuk tries to barge in, and he is stopped in his track. Crowd calling for holding, but the play goes right on. And it's Pearson being flattened. The Jets trying to tie the game here. Rouse hits Tkachuk. Tkachuk hit him back. Ulanov comes in to hit Pearson. McIlwain flipped it up to center, and it's flipped back in by Drew. Puttbank covering up, picking it off the board. Leaves back. Nearing the 9-minute mark of the second. The pass to McIlwain, and he's nailed it. Center ice. And here's the penalty called against Winnipeg. It's a hooking call. Against the Winnipeg Jets. Leafs in a power play when we get back.
Special Drive, the evolution of beer.
Ever get that feeling you're in the wrong commercial? Introducing the new Colt, the affordable import that reflects the lifestyle you've always wanted. Your own. The new Colt from Chrysler. All you have to do is drive one.
Mike Eagles draws a penalty on this neutral zone hook right here on Dave McIlwain. 11:41 to go in the second period. 1-0 Leafs, and they're on the power play.
0-for-2 tonight in that department. And it's Todd Gill quarterbacking at the blue line. The shot, the quick one, hit a leg in front of the net, and the Jets will send the Leafs back. Leafs at Ellett and Gill, Borshevsky, Gilmore, and Endrychuk. 1-0 Toronto. And they move up. Ellett to Endrychuk. He was behind everybody. Couldn't get the pass, though. And Essence has to slow the pace again. There'll be a faceoff to his right.
Now the Leafs are playing a much better defensive team game tonight. Winnipeg's a lot like Detroit, a dangerous group of offensive players. Bob Rouse makes a nice play right here on the Winnipeg forward. The puck gets past him. Rouse pays no attention and takes the man. And Mironov, exactly the same play as he does his job. A pair of Leaf defensemen who are in sync tonight.
Leafs with the extra man on this power play. Everybody up with a minute 36 left on it. The penalty to Eagles for hooking. Carlisle, no problem. Finds the opening to clear it. Sending Gill back. Ellett remains on. No change up front. Gilmore, Borshevsky, and Endrychuk. Endrychuk cruising the blue line near the Winnipeg zone all alone. Nobody saw him. Gilmore. Stick handle through. And then the Jets pick it up off Gilmore.
And it was shot down the ice by Shannon. He's going off. 109 left in the penalty. Halep comes out. Hitting Borshevsky on the right wing. Here's Andrechuk. Andrechuk is tied up. The Jets get it out of there again. And Halep turns back with it. Crowd restless now. One more action toward the Winnipeg net. Borshevsky can't get a pass by Carlisle. And he's going to clear it down the ice. Carlisle heading off. Some pretty good penalty killing by the Winnipeg Jets. 40 seconds left in that penalty. The Eagles, 1-0 Toronto. Leafs have changed. Marinov, Ellen remains on. Marinov, the other defenseman, and here's Clark. Krasilinski couldn't get the skate on the blue line. And he's offside.
The Leafs having an awful time on this power play, getting the puck into the Winnipeg goal. They seem to be reluctant to shoot it in, and Winnipeg won't let them carry it in. And we've seen a couple of pucks stripped from the Leafs. And the expression on Pat Burns' face tells you all you want to know about how poorly the Leafs' power play is played with 27 seconds left in this penalty to Mike Eagle.
And from this faceoff, the Leafs are going to be sent back over center again. Marinov put it up for Ellett, and he had to poke it into the corner. Pushing this, he can't get there quickly enough. Swept away from him the second time. And it's shut down the ice by Housley. That'll kill the penalty. Only 6 seconds left. Penalty to Eagles. So before the Leafs get to center, he'll be out of the box. He is out. And Krasilinski shoots it in. The Jets back, having killed off that manpower advantage. And they still trail by just the one goal. Zezel scored it at 12:23 of the first. Pearson ahead to Clark. Clark and Pearson coming in. Hard shot by Clark. And Essence for sure playing solid goal for Winnipeg tonight. He moved quickly to stop that one.
Did Wendell Clark ever give the how do you do to Ulanov before he got the shot away? Wendell not known for his great stick handling, but Ulanov came out to take Wendell out, and watch the move he makes on him. A quick little move right there, and that allowed him to get to the top of the circle. Clark tried to beat Essence on the short side, but no such luck.
Hot man, the other end is having quite a time of it here in the second period so far. Winnipeg has not had a shot on goal in this period.
Yep. Well, when Paddock saw Ulanov miss Clark, he pulled him off the ice.
Total shot, 14-10 in favor of the Maple Leafs.
There's the move I'm talking about right there. He just snakes by him, gets into the top of the circle. Look where Essence is, though. Boy, there's not much net in the line of vision of Wendell Clark.
A little bit on the short side. Clark thought he might hit it, but Essence had the glove there. Good save by Essence. Shot by Rouse. Ricochets off the leg. Ekberg trying one. Butterfly stops. Here's a loose puck off the goal post. Zezel nearly had a second. It hit the post. Little East come close. The Jets regroup and get it out over the line. Steen passing off to the far side. Olofsson trying to bring it in. He's tied up in front of the net. And it's Pierre DeBerg, and he was checked for center ice. 8:45 left in the second period. Toronto 1. Winnipeg nothing. Puck is shut off the boards. Comes back out over the line. And near center is Olofsson. He brings it in on goal. Can't get a shot through. Not cleared. Still in there. Bird comes back. Trying to tie up his man. He's Tkachuk. Tkachuk picked it loose. Then chased it. Kalani is covered. And Lawler turns back to center ice. Passed ahead by Housley. Leafs will take over in their own zone. 8 minutes left in the second period. 1-0 Toronto. Here's Krasilinski moving up, taking the shot. He's going around the net with it. Krasilinski tied up, shakes off that check from Housley. Left it in the corner. Foligno comes in to dig it out. Foligno played it off the boards. It hit a skate. Clark was there, and it was Clark.
The puck hit. Allen kept it in. Not for long. Shot to center ice. Barnes trying to go in. It is centered. Here to Jack. Ripping the shot high with Davidoff. Good chance for Winnipeg. But Davidoff shot it high. They go in again. Barnes and Davidoff. Hot band block that. Rebound is there. And the Leafs hang on. They do not get it out right away. Hill moving back to the net. King was hit inside the line by Foligno. King didn't like it. We'll watch that as play develops to center and rolled into the zone by Ellis. Foligno now is going off. 7 minutes remaining in the period. Long pass to center ice. Davidoff turning around with it. Coming in with King and Burns. Davidoff stick handling in there. Trying to drop it back. And the Leafs hand with Chuck stopped it but couldn't get it out. Kept in by King. Leafs come back on the ice. Led by Gilmore again. Gilmore ran into a stone wall. Ulanov stood up to him. Shannon shot it around the net. It comes out over the line to center. And Berehowski will rip it back in for Toronto. There's Borshevsky on it, and he backs off. Saw a hit coming. Eakins had him lined up. Shannon takes that pass neatly. Comes in over the line, and Ty Domi won't get a chance to play it. Potback caught it high, and he held on to it. 6:12 left in the second. 1-0.
Some things you buy for today. Some things you buy for tomorrow. And some things you buy for the day after that. Durability. At Sears, it means something.
Some say that we are not alone in the universe. Others say intelligent life surrounds us. Paramount Pictures presents the true story of one man who just may know for sure.
They took him.
Fire in the Sky, based on the Travis Walton case, starts Friday, March 12th at theaters everywhere.
We've been offering value for 40 years now. Because if we ever stopped, you'd stop coming in. And who could blame you? Value. At Sears, it means something.
We have 6:12 remaining in the second period and coming up in our second intermission. After 40 minutes, we invite you to stay tuned. And Ron McLean will take it after 40 minutes. 1-0 Toronto. Vezel the goal in the first. Osborne the only assist. Gallup putting the puck on the glass and over it into the crowd.
Well, both teams playing very conservative hockey. Solani showed signs of being a threat tonight in the first 7 or 8 minutes of the game, but we haven't noticed him since. He's the lock for the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year. Gretzky said he ought to get some votes for the Hart Trophy. Nobody's ever won those two in the same year. 72, Dryden won the Calder, runner-up for the Hart. 70, Esposito won the Calder and was runner-up for the Hart.
That man you just looking at, ready to stop Carlisle. He can't! It went over his shoulder. He was going down. Carlisle fired the shot from inside the blue line. And it went high. I'm not sure if Felix Potvin saw it.
Well, I don't think he did see it, and Carlisle got a lot on it. The puck came right off the faceoff back to Randy Carlisle. It was kind of half rolling, and he shot it. And it went by and through a few players. Here's a better look, and maybe we can see what happened. It may have been entirely screened as Potvin appeared surprised, and it may have hit a Leaf defenseman in the shaft of the stick. Carlisle, who at one time was one of the better offensive defensemen in the league, gets his second point this season and his first goal.
Randy Carlisle from Thomas Steen, time 13:57.
From Steen because he won the faceoff cleanly. Right back to Carlisle. 13:57, the time of the tying goal by Randy Carlisle. So the Jets to tie it. 1-1 now with 5:40 left in the second period. Shannon flipped it over the line. It is Marinoff for Toronto to McIlwain. McIlwain coming in. Drop back to Pearson. Bullet shot. Stop. Good save by Essenza again. He kicked out the right pad and made a big save on that hard shot. He's keeping in. Rouse drilled one wide. It's loose. McIlwain scores. McIlwain gives the Leafs the lead again.
An awful wallop in the corner there. The puck goes back to the point. Bob Rose misses the net, but it comes back past two players right to McIlwain, who puts it in with 5:15 to go in the second period. The rebound off the end of the rink. Essenza falls and misses stopping the rebound coming off the end of the rink and then can't recover. He did get his pad on it, but not enough.
Number 7, Dave McIlwain. Assist number 3, Bob Rose. Time 14:45. Dave McIlwain from Bob Rouse. Time 14:45.
14:45, the time of that go-ahead goal by McIlwain. Rouse got the assist. So it is now 2-1 Toronto. Jets fighting hard to tie it, and they did. And then the Leafs got that goal. Carlisle had tied it for Winnipeg. Winnipeg looking for another tying marker here. The puck is shot in wide of the net. The Leafs do not clear it. It is Rouse trying to shoot it high, and he does this time, and it goes all the way down the ice. The goals 48 seconds apart. First, Carlisle tying it at 1, and now McIlwain 48 seconds later, and the Leafs are ahead again.
Well, earlier in the shift, Bob Essenza made the best stop of the night by either goalie when he stopped Pearson, but on this one, he lost his footing and then couldn't stop the rebound off the end of the rink and was in no position to handle the McIlwain shot. A little bit of luck on the Leafs' part and not a great play by Bob Essenza, who I'm sure would like to try to stand up and stop that rebound coming out if he had a second chance. He has been sharp tonight. 17-12 the shot. Winnipeg, a pretty good offensive team. The Leafs doing a wonderful job so far keeping the chance against down.
Back to the net with 4:30 left in the second period. And his team up on Winnipeg 2-1. Gill forced to come back again. Davidoff in forechecking. Gill sidesteps him. Put a nice pass ahead to Gilmore. He lifts one in wide of the Winnipeg net. Slapping at it is Ulanov. Leafs keep it in at center. Koshelinski at the side of the net. Now back at the goal is Gilmore. Up front. Battle score! Foligno! And it's 3-1 Maple Leafs.
Well, you can tell Mike Foligno, who's playing his second game after sitting out 6 in a row, hasn't been able to practice that famous jump because he went down after he scored the goal. A lovely little pass here from Doug Gilmore to Foligno, who maneuvers in position to make the shot and makes it 3-1. Here's a better look. Foligno makes the play to step into the opening right here to get the chance. And on a little short 6 or 8 foot pass, he puts it by Essenza. And there's the jump, and he falls to get a 4.3 on the jump, but a 10.0 on the goal.
Gilmore's 800th career point. 102 on this season now. Gilmore assisting on Foligno's goal. Koshelinski also drawing an assist. 15:59, the time of the goal. Giving the Leafs a 3-1 lead. And the second period winding down. McIlwain trying to stay onside. Can't. Doesn't matter. It was cleared down the ice by Olesen. All the way down the ice, and Mironov takes it behind his own net. 3:20 left for the second period. The Leafs are up 3-1 down, coming out again. Mironov pokes it down on the left side for Rouse, who shoots it in. There's Clark. He can't find it. Kennedy takes it for Winnipeg and fired it off the glass, and it gets by the defenseman down into the Maple Leaf zone. 3 minutes left in the period. High pass, knocked down by Pearson. He lost. Kachuk shot it in. Pearson hit him. He did. Kachuk hit him back. Clark hit Kachuk. They're having words. And they're still yapping as they start now to move away. Kachuk and Pearson at the far side might drop the glove. I don't know. Shoving, pushing, talking, nothing.
Hydomi and Pearson rocking it over after Clark and Kachuk nearly got going.
When it only comes around once a year,
it's called Bock. Molson presents Bock Reserve 93, a darker, more full-bodied 6% brew available now in limited quantities at regular beer prices. Try it while you can.
We saw that we could move the windshield forward on a sedan and reduce wind noise while increasing visibility. We saw that moving the wheels toward the corners would result in greater stability and more passenger room. We saw that this cab forward design is not only more aerodynamic, it looks and feels like nothing else on the road. And when you drive it, you'll see it for what it is, a radical departure. The all-new Intrepid from Chrysler.
Although man is composed of over 90% water, he doesn't have to feel wet. For effective, long-lasting protection against wetness and odor, use Arid Extra Dry Antiperspirant for Men. Dryness designed for men.
Okay, it's Domi and Pearson on sportsmanlike conduct penalties, handed out by Denny Morrell here, and Pat Burns, the lead coach, is quite upset.
Well, he's quite upset about one of two things. He thinks that Kachuk and Pearson should have got the penalty, and then Domi jumps in to Kachuk's rescue. And this is what Pat's arguing about. That he thinks the Jets should get two penalties.
Look at the right glove of Domi. He had been on the ice all right. He circled all the way over from the left wing to the other side when Kachuk and Pearson were pushing each other, very likely. And Kachuk very quickly jumped off the ice, and Domi took over. But Domi and Pearson are in the penalty box. With 2:41 left in the period.
Four skaters aside, Bob, this is the time when Bill Housley could jump into the rush to turn a 2-on-2 into a 3-on-2.
Carlisle had tied the game for Winnipeg, and then the Leafs got two quick goals in 2 minutes and 2 seconds to take a 3-1 lead. With 2:20 left in the second period, Housley back icing, called against Toronto, and it's getting a little chippy.
Well, it's always a little unnerving when you're coaching and the president sits right there where he can observe how your team's playing and how you're handling the bench. Shankro, Cliff Fletcher, not nearly so active. He's about 300 feet away from Burns, high above the ice surface here. Assistant coach Mike Murphy. And there's Mr. Stavro, the owner of the Leafs, and Dave Keon, who is the alumni guest. The Toronto Maple Leafs under Cliff Fletcher making the alumni of the Leafs feel much more involved with the current Leafs.
He nearly got in on that faceoff. He won it cleanly again. And he nearly got in for a shot. Esposito will come out. Scooping in right to Osborne, though. He nearly set up Dezel. The Winnipeg Jets come out, led by Solani and Housley. Housley and Steen over there. Back to the line, though. Lawler's shot. That's why. Solani looking for the rebound and takes it off the board. One hand on the step. He's strong. Solani can't get in, though. Lawler can't get in. Osborne pokes it off his stick out. 1:40 left in the period. 3-1 Toronto. Winnipeg moving up with a long shot. No problem for Hot Pound. That long shot by Steen. On the net. Gilmore starts the Leafs out again. It is Lefebvre bringing it up over the Winnipeg line, and he dumped it off to the corner. There goes Gilmore to pick it up quickly. Left it, a quick shot by Andrechuk. Here's Andrechuk again. Gilmore! And he can't put it by Esenson. Two big chances. 1:10 left in the period. It is dropped neatly. Davidoff tried to return it. In front of the net with a hard shot. Up high now, deflected. Barnes had a good chance. But they had the angle covered. And Richuk and Gill, the defenseman moving in deep. Gill back of the net with the puck, looking around for somebody open. Can't find anybody, so he hangs on to it. 40 seconds left in the period, and Espinosa decides he'd better go down on it and hang on to it. Gill is in there pushing and shoving with Ulanov.
Frederick Olsson having a devil of a time handling big Dave Anderchuk in front of the net.
We have this update now, and here again is Ron McLean.
Thank you, Bob. The Montreal Canadiens and Minnesota North Stars at the Met Center with the 2-1 North Stars. Here's the equalizer by John LeClair. Brian Murray and the Red Wings are in town. Brian sitting with Serge Savard watching this one. 2-2 in the second period in Bloomington.
Dave Anderchuk, a tough guy to handle in front of the net. Frederick Olsson, number four, does his best. They both go down, and then Olsson tries to take him again. It's hard to tie up that guy's stick and take that big long reach away from him. He's well over 200 pounds, and that's one of the longest sticks in the National Hockey League.
He had two great chances to score for the Maple Leafs on that last skirmish. 42 seconds left in the period. Pearson and Domi will be out of the penalty box as they drop the puck in. They're back on the ice. Domi taps one at center, and it goes up over the line. He and Pearson collide and then skate their own way. It's inside the Winnipeg line again. Pearson in there bumping with Lawler. There's Domi going after the puck in his own zone. Slapped the pass to center ice to Eagles. Eagles tries to go for the net, but Rouse has that figure. It is centered, and Gilmore around the net with 14 seconds left in the period. It is lifted high, and it goes rolling inside the Winnipeg line. Only 5 seconds left in the period now as the Jets, Eagles, he gets to the center, and then Borsato got over the line but does not get a chance to put a shot on the net. And little pushing and shoving at the horn. Domi is in there again, and it was Pearson. He and Domi were having quite a few words, so this may not be over. Domi leaves for the Winnipeg bench, or rather dressing room, and Pearson is headed off now. The officials get them apart. Coming up in our second intermission, after 40 minutes. The score after two periods here in Toronto, the Maple Leafs 3 and the Jets of Winnipeg 1.
RCA VCR with VCR Plus built in. To record a show, just look for the VCR Plus code in your TV listing. Then punch it in. It's as simple as that. So if you had it with your old VCR, get rid of it. And get the new one with Cable Box Channel Control. The first VCR that changes channels on your cable box. Finally, a VCR that everyone can program.
I'm going public. I watch primetime news at 9 o'clock on CBC every night. It's, to me, the best news on television. So I watch it, and I like Peter Mansbridge very much.
Satellite was launched. It is a story in itself.
He's really good at what he does.
I'm Peter Mansbridge.
He's also cute. I'm sure most broadcasters wouldn't want to be known as cute, but I'm sorry, he's cute.
Hey, Dad, check out my new car.
How can you afford this?
But, Dad...
The all-new Toyota Corolla.
In my day, we knew the value of a dollar. Didn't I teach you anything about money?
But, Dad...
Roomier, quieter, and now a better value than ever.
What have you got to say for yourself?
It's a Corolla!
A Corolla? Why didn't you say so? Come on, kids, let's motor.
Did we mention more power? The all-new Corolla by Toyota, a welcome addition to any family.
When it's time to kick back, what Eat More gives is dark, chewy toffee loaded with peanuts. Real chewy and not too sweet tasting. So what Eat More tastes is time. Eat More. It's a real long chew.
If you think controlling wild oats early, before they compete with your crop, is important, you come to the right place. If you're tilling less than you used to, but still expect excellent wild oat control, you've come to the right place.
CBC News with Wendy Meslin.
Here are some of the stories we're following for tonight's National. Canada's next prime minister will be picked on the second weekend of June. That's when the Conservative Party will wrap up its leadership convention. The party's national executive announced the date at a meeting today in Ottawa. It also announced a spending limit for the candidates, $900,000 each. The government's House leader won't be running in the next election. Harvey Andre told his Calgary riding today that it's time for a changing of the guard. South Africa's constitutional talks will resume next month. A number of groups, both black and white, will talk about plans for a non-racial election. And in Waco, Texas today, an appeal. The FBI called on the leader of a heavily armed religious sect to surrender. We'll have more on those stories later on the National. Now, back to Hockey Night in Canada.
After 40 minutes, brought to you by Fiberglass Canada and Owens Corning Company.
Tonight on After 40 Minutes, MVP candidate Doug Gilmour. And a word about the future of television sports coverage.
When you're looking for the best insulation for your home, remember,
la, 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 la.
Not all insulation is the same.
La, 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 la.
Watch out for imposters.
La, la.
Do it right. Do it pink.
Aerobic strength greater than almost every sport. Yet when the judges are watching, ballet is grace under pressure. Ashley Herod. Magic. Part of the best freestyle ski team in the world. Canada's team. The secret is out.
Welcome back to After 40 Minutes. Thursday morning, a CP story which made front page news in many centers across Canada dealt with violence in the National Hockey League and on television. A CP story which was later refuted by the chairman and CEO of the Canadian Association of Broadcasters, Michael McCabe. Let's begin with the story as it appeared in the Toronto Star. At least I have that copy with me here. The headline was, New TV Code Would KO Those Ugly Hockey Brawls. In the story, it claimed the proposal unanimously approved by the Board of Directors of the Canadian Association of Broadcasters, but still under discussion with the Federal Broadcast Regulator, which is the CRTC, would see television cameras turn away from fights when they break out during the course of hockey games. Obviously, a lot of hockey fans, television commentators and broadcasters nationwide were struck by the story. Michael McCabe, as I say, who represents the CAB, quickly came out with a statement that, in essence, termed the report inaccurate. He went on to say, obviously, the television coverage of the games is a matter that falls within the purview of organized hockey. The intent of their draft code... Keith Spicer, the chairman of the CRTC, has asked all broadcasters in Canada to draft codes that would deal with violence on television. The intent of the CAB's draft code provision is that broadcasters should not exploit violent aspects of sporting events. Would have been great to hear from Michael in After 40 Minutes today. We offered several opportunities, anytime, any place, for members of the CAB or Michael himself to come on the program in that hockey's been implicated and the word violence has been attached, but they declined, apparently too busy with working on communication and the future of that in Canada. One gentleman who was involved in this story, which came out Thursday and is with us this evening, is Michael D. Smith, who is the director of the LaMarche Program on Violence at York University in Toronto. Mike's involvement in the story is as follows. He has done a study on the subject of violence in hockey, and in the article it said Smith carried out a large random survey of Toronto hockey players, young Toronto hockey players, asking them whether they had learned illegal ways to hit an opponent by watching professionals on TV. Some 60% said they had. Joining me in the studio is Mike Smith. Mike, your reaction to your involvement in the story, how did that come about?
I'm not really quite sure. I got a phone call on the day the story broke, the day before, from a reporter who I thought was calling from Ottawa, asking me had I heard about this news, and I said no. He told me the news and then asked me my opinion on it and what I knew about the subject and so forth, and in the course of our conversation, I mentioned the study I had done some years ago, and that's how it got into the Star.
When was this study conducted?
The study was done a long time ago, in the late 1970s, in fact, and it was published in a variety of places and talked about in the media at that time. And I think, however, it is still relevant. It was done a while ago, but the findings are still generalizable, I think, and worth talking about it again.
Obviously, hockey fans would point to the 1970s as a period when the Broad Street Bullies, Philadelphia Flyers, the Big Bad Bruins in Boston, the game seemed more aggressive than it does now. The rules have changed. Don't you think that changes, perhaps, the findings?
Well, the professional game has changed, although how much I'm not quite sure. There's been some cosmetic changes. I don't think fundamentally it has changed over many decades. In fact, players still fight, for example. We don't have the mass brawls, that's true, but we still have dirty play and cheap shots and illegal use of the stick that results in injuries and lots of fighting, so I don't think that it has changed fundamentally. And you can't prove that it's changed or not changed by calling on statistics such as penalty minutes, because they vary within a season and over the seasons depending on whether there's a decision to crack down on penalties and so forth. So I think it is relevant.
I'd like to follow on the point, though, that you feel what's happening, let's say on Hockey Night in Canada, has an impact on youth who are watching. Explore that and try and further that theme.
Well, I'll refer again to the study. We did ask what they had learned, and a significant portion of the players said they had learned a variety of dirty tricks, acts of violence, how to fight and so forth, the techniques of fighting and other acts of violence. We then asked them to describe what they had learned, and they did so, sometimes in colorful detail. How to trip properly is a phrase, a response that stays in my mind, as a matter of fact. We then asked another question: how often have you performed what you learned in your own games this past season? And about two-thirds of all the players said at least once, and most of the players said many times. So this is pretty concrete, direct evidence, I think, that players learn these things from watching the pros on TV, and they perform them in their own games.
Mike, you deny that the question was leading in any way, shape, or form, and that's the only concern I had, that perhaps if you ask a youngster, do you learn tactics such as these from NHLers, they might think it's cool to say yes.
Well, there's always that possibility, but there are a variety of ways of doing this kind of research that that guard against that, and it's far too complicated to go in now, and it would take too much time, but I can say that it was done. The study was done very, very carefully, and there's no evidence, in fact, that players responded in the way that you suggest they could.
No, and you have done a lot of very credible work in this area, and I'm not disputing that. We only have enough time for one point that I think should be covered. With the CAB, who are private broadcasters, wouldn't affect the CBC or pay in specialty services like TSN, but would you like to see this direction taken, that cameras pan away? Seems like censorship to me, but what's your thought on that?
I have mixed feelings about it. I found it intriguing because, for one thing, it focuses attention on the problem of violence in professional hockey and in and fighting in particular, and it gets people thinking and talking about it, and I think that is good. On the other hand, as you say, it smacks of paternalism and censorship, and that bothers me a lot. I would much prefer to see a different course of action considered. I don't know how realistic it is, but it's maybe more realistic than what has been considered now. The verbal commentary that accompanies a fight is very, very important, and it seems to me much of the time that I watch now, the color commentators and the player men, the play-by-play guys, commend the fights and the fighters and the tough guys and talk about the best 10 fights of the season and who has the best right hand in the game, and sometimes they do this, they out-and-out cheerlead the fights and the fighters, and sometimes they condone it simply by not condemning what, after all, is against the official rules of the sport, and it could be argued in many instances the law of the land. So if the verbal commentary was made negative rather than positive, as it often is, then I think this could have a significant impact.
Mike, you'll have to be sure to watch Coach's Corner this evening on Hockey Night in Canada for Don Cherry's remarks. I really thank you for coming in today. I know you're very busy.
Thank you.
Mike Smith from the LaMarche Program on Violence at York University in Toronto. Ironically, we're...
Third period underway in Winnipeg with a man advantage. Pearson drew a minor penalty at the 20-minute mark of period number two. So Winnipeg looking to get close. Here's a shot that deflected off a stick and high. Knocked down at the blue line. The Leafs trying to get it out. They cannot. Rouse now gets an opportunity, and he picks the hole to shoot it down the ice right on the net. 1:05 left in the penalty to the Leafs. Pearson. Winnipeg on the march. Coming in is Olsson, and he shot it off the boards behind the net. Solani missed it. Berg is in there looking for it against Steen. Steen slipped it back. Housley tried to pass it along the line. And it's Gill who will pick the opening again for Toronto. Back to Ellett, he decides. And he finds the opening to clear it. 38 seconds left in the penalty to the Maple Leafs. Rob Pearson. 3-1, Toronto leading here in the third period. Housley put a shot in high. That comes back down to Ellett. Ellett shoved it in behind his own net, and there's Gill again. And he got it out over the line. It's center ice, grabbed by Krushelnitsky. And it's Gill catching up to the play with a shot on the short side. He missed by a couple of feet. 10 seconds left on this power play. Barnes trying to go in. Stop. And now he waits. A pass back to Olsson. His shot right in front. Score! Good passing play as Pearson stepped from the penalty box. And the Winnipeg Jets make it close again. They make it 3-2, Toronto.
Well, it was a great pass from Olsson to Davidoff, and he put it in a big hurry. Felix Potvin, no chance at all. And there's the pass. He kind of faked the shot and threw the cross-ice pass. Davidoff on his wrong wing. Stopped it and put it in. Now there's no way Potvin can get over in time in any kind of shape to make that save.
Says number 4, Frederick Olsson, and number 14, Sue Barnes. Time 2:03.
2:03 is the time of the goal, so not a power play goal by Davidoff.
Time 2:03.
Pearson out of the penalty box, 3 seconds when that one went in. It is 3-2 now, Toronto leading Winnipeg. Well, the Jets climb right back into the game. McIlwain comes to center ice. Shoots it in wide of the Winnipeg net. Out of the goal, trying to clear it. It is King who gets it ahead. King moving it up to center. That is Drews trying to find some room, and finds none. Into the far corner, King again. Hooked it back along the boards, now turns and fired a shot wide of the net. Another drive is right on, and Potvin stopped that. Puck lifted out to Clark. He is checked on the play by Lawler. Words behind the play, and a scrap behind the play. King and Pearson are going at it. And the officials stand back and let him go. His roundhouse missing twice. Three times. Left Hoskin. Goodness gracious. These are two heavyweights.
Some long range punches.
Tired heavyweights, and they're still going. Oh, how can you not comment?
I'm just watching here.
Oh,
I hope Mr. Tony is listening to the crowd.
Somebody tell Don Jerry to sit down and relax downstairs.
Well, that was a long, drawn-out affair.
Whatever.
Where there were many punches thrown, and there had to be a few landed. You can see King cut over the left eye, the right eye, and here's how it started. King took quite a healthy run at Pearson along the board. 5 minutes apiece for fighting. Here's how it started. And about 2 or 3 minutes later, it ended. King cut his eye and his hand.
Tough customer.
Let's take a break for this update, and here's Ron.
Okay, thanks, Bob. I got Don to quit yelling long enough to do this update from the Met Center in Bloomington. Russ Cortnell has scored to give the Stars a 3-2 lead against the Canadiens in the third at Bloomington. Gagne and Modano draw assists on Cortnell's goal.
Thank you, Ron. Pearson in the penalty box. King on the Winnipeg side of the penalty box. 5 minutes each for fighting at the 3-minute mark of the third period.
Hartford has a stranglehold on Vancouver in Hartford. Just showed you the Cortnell goal of Minnesota. Worked one for Boston this afternoon in OT. Quebec mothers the New York Rangers in Quebec City. Calgary making it a little bit of an effort to get back into that one. And the puck hasn't dropped at the Great Western Forum yet.
Berg shooting the puck in back to the Winnipeg net. It comes all the way back out to the blue line. It'll be cleared by the Jets. Up the center, racing in is Tkachuk. Hot pass, cut that long shot. Osborne wasting little time. It got over the board. At the Leaf bench.
Well, we've just
and the play is stopped.
Sorry, Bob, we just received word that Brett Hull has signed a 5-year contract for the St. Louis Blues at more money than you and I combined.
Yep.
Brett Hull and Andrew Chuck tied for the power play goal lead in the National League with 25.
Toronto 3, Winnipeg 2, nearing the 4-minute mark of the third period. Lefebvre skates the center. Dump the puck in for Dazzle. Dazzle, who opened the scoring of the game back in the first, 12-23. Solani looks at a pass across the blue line, and then the return pass behind him. Somehow he picked it up and carried on, and Lefebvre carried it in on the board. Back out for Berg of Toronto. He comes to center with Dazzle and Osborne. Osborne can't catch up to it. There is Berg, sidestepping ahead. Continues on along the boards, and Osborne without the helmet in the corner. Coming out with it now. Lost control of it. And the Winnipeg Jets get it up to center ice. Osborne is nailed as he was near the line. Now Gilmore comes in, throwing punches on Igor Ulanov. And this big pileup between the two benches.
Ulanov came down with the stick after the hit by Osborne right over the head when Osborne had no helmet on. And Doug Gilmore watched it all and came roaring in. And in a game that's been pretty quiet, the last 5 minutes has erupted in to a bitter affair.
We've had major penalties already in this third period. Pearson and King in a slugfest got 5 each for fighting. Osborne was clipped as he was heading off to the Leaf bench, and Gilmore jumped in. And now Ellett might be going.
Ellett and Eakin. Dave Ellett doesn't get into this very often.
They are going. Todd Gill looks like he might have something going with Igor Ulanov. They're paired off away from the crowd. And Denny Morrell is looking around, wondering who to try to separate.
I have to wonder whether he's going to get Doug Gilmore for third man in. It would mean an automatic game suspension.
The linesman in between Eakins and Ellett now. They'll get them separated. And they're skating toward the penalty box. This is Ulanov, number 5. Igor Ulanov. He and Osborne were the first to kind of go at it. Osborne was flipped. He was out the helmet, you remember, down near the Winnipeg net, and was heading off.
Well, he took Ulanov into the boards right here after he'd had his helmet removed. And watch Ulanov after the collision. Bong, right on the head of Mark Osborne. And of course, Gilmore sees this, and he roars into the rescue of teammate Osborne. Well, how Denny Morrell sees all this remains to be seen. probably Osborne and Ulanoff should get original penalties. And then only Denny Morrell knows what happens now.
All this at 4:09 of the third period. The game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Ford, a dealership that goes beyond matching any price you'll find anywhere on a full line of new cars and trucks. Our management team with over 100 years experience is committed to providing you complete satisfaction through sales, finance, service, body shop, parts, and accessories. We want your business and we're working to give you our best. So call us toll free today, 1-800-667-1320. Stacy Ford, North Battleford. Where else?
This whole nasty little affair started early in the shift when Osborne and Ulanoff collided behind the Winnipeg net. And here it is right here. They're going to go out of your frame and then come back into your picture. And it happens right here as Osborne continues on to make the check. Osborne helmet comes off and Ulanoff's doesn't quite come off. And then they went back up to center ice and you know the rest of the story.
Referee Denny Morrell is at the penalty box now, handing out the penalties, and here they are.
Number 5, Igor Ulanov, 2 minutes for high sticking. Number 52, Dallas Eakins, 5 minutes for fighting. Toronto penalty to number 4, Dave Ellett, 5 minutes for fighting. Number 21, Mark Osborne, 2 minutes for elbowing. And number 93, Doug Gilmore, 2 minutes for roughing.
So the lead for shorthanded as Gilmore got a roughing penalty. And Winnipeg will get another power play. They're within a goal of the Maple Leafs.
Well, here's the original two combatants in this whole thing. Osborne probably deserves a penalty there, but what about the two-hander right over his head? And that's the only 2 minutes Ulanoff gets. Burns not very happy with that one. And the Leafs come out on the short end of the stick and have to kill another power play to score 3-2 Toronto. 15:51 to go in the third period.
So she's fired up for a whale of a finish here at Maple Leaf Gardens. Morrell is hoping that things will settle down. One goal separating the two teams now. The Leafs opened up a 3-1 lead after two periods. And they scored two goals in a minute and 14 seconds. Winnipeg getting one back. Davidov here in the third. At 2:03, it's 3-2. Toronto leading. Winnipeg on a power play now. And here they come. Olofsson trying to get away from Krushelnicki and having a tough time trying to do it. Now he seeks the help of Housley and he shoots it in. That is LeFay with a puck back of the net. He comes out in front of his own goal and then it was cleared the length of the ice by Krushelnicki. The crowd getting into it now. A minute 20 seconds left in the penalty. Winnipeg power play coming up. Pass to center ice and in over the line is Steen. Steen's cut the pass and gets the return. Now here's a shot, a bullet shot that was blocked in front of the net. Zazzle stood up and stopped it. McIlwain in with Zazzle. McIlwain skating in hard. Housley comes back to flip it in along the board. Barnes clears it out. McIlwain was stuck. The play goes right on. Tkachuk is coming to the net. At the line, Olofsson. Gave it to Housley, no shot. His shot right in front. Rebound! And Potvin is down. Red light not on. Big crowd in the crease area. We welcome you people who have joined us from British Columbia and that game in Hartford. This is Bob Cole with Harry Neal. It's Maple Leaf Gardens, and we've got a hot one going tonight at the Garden. Senzel for the lead in the first. Carlisle tied it in the second. McIlwain and Foligno gave the lead to 3-1 lead, and Davidoff here in the third, getting the Jets within one, and boy, they come close here, the sixth celebrating a goal, but we still have not seen the sign, but watch it, you'll see it probably over the line.
Well, Potvin makes the save, Bob, but he's in the net, and I think they're going to go upstairs to the video goal judge, although he has to be absolutely sure and see the puck over the line. It looks like it should be over the line, but can you find it? That overhead camera doesn't show it as clearly as you might think.
Goal judge did not turn on the light, but of course he doesn't have the angle that you at home have, as we do now, looking at it on our monitors. There's Potvin, back deep. Now his glove. Is the puck in the glove? Jenny Morrell, the referee tonight. These two teams really go at each other here in the third period, is talking to the video replay.
Well, he has to see it in the net. He can't assume it might be in there.
No goal as the puck did not cross the net.
No goal. The crowd here at the Garden letting everybody know how they feel. No goal.
That's a tough call, Bob, because it looks like it should be in. But you have to see the puck over the line. Now, it hit Potvin in the chest, and he's completely in the net. Delaney thinks it's in to the right of Potvin. If you can't see the puck, you can't guess it's in.
Now, there's the glove. See the glove?
Regardless of what we think,
it is still 3-2 Toronto. To the left of Potvin. The shot for 21-19 in favor of the Maple Leafs. Essence of the goaltender for Winnipeg stopping that one. And he's been sharp tonight. This has been a good hockey game. No question, Barnes coming in for Winnipeg. Barnes in too far for a shot on the net. Davidoff on the other side. He has scored for Winnipeg here in the third to make it close. Fake the shot. Back to the line. Olsson gives him another crack at it. He slipped the pass into the side. Comes back to him. And out to the line again. Olsson rolls it in there. And it's Krzysztof rolls clear. He shoots it down the ice as Gilmore comes out of the penalty box. And Gilmore is in. He's quite physical down this third period. Berg going in to hit Housley. The Winnipeg Jets come back to center. Pass missing Shannon. Mironov. And Gill. Back to Mironov. Mironov from the blue line. A hard shot booted back out by Essenza. Nearing the 7-minute mark of the third period. Mironov a pass ahead to center ice. Hamburg trying to stride in there to catch up to it. It's docked in on the boards in the corner. Andrzejczyk still there with Borshevsky. It's Borshevsky with the puck. Gilmore now. Pass to Andrzejczyk. And Essence got his stick in the way of that pass to deflect it. Salami coming in. Salami! A shot blocked by Potvin. What a great rush by Salami, though. Back out for Toronto. Andrzejczyk over the Winnipeg line. Scores! Andrzejczyk makes it 4-2 Toronto.
Dave Andrzejczyk comes down the ice and then starts to cross, and from about 46 feet out, slaps it to the side of the net he's leaving from. Andrzejczyk rarely scores from this far out, but that's a tough stop for the goalie because Essence had to move left as Andrzejczyk went to the left. And then Andrzejczyk came back and put it off the post on the short side. A great shot and nearly an impossible stop
for goalie Bob Essence. And the Leafs are ahead by two again on Dave Andrzejczyk's 42nd goal of the season. 7-13, the time of the goal by Andrzejczyk. Mironov assisted, and so did the goaltender, Felix Potvin. Four to Toronto. Very spirited game here at Maple Leaf Gardens tonight. We're nearing the 8-minute mark of the third period. Toronto, I'm off. Within a minute and 14 seconds in the second, it was 3-1. Davidov made it 3-2 at 2:03 of the third, and now that goal by Andrzejczuk at 7:13. 4-2 Toronto. To center ice, Barahowski shoots it in. Eagles picks his man on the board. Lafave got a shot away. Messi just scooped it away with his stick high on the glass. Baumgartner kicks it loose. Lawler starts in front of his own net. A pass ahead on the left side and near center. Baumgartner thought he had the Chuck lined up, but he did not. Chuck saw him all the way. Here's his centering pass, and Foligno will move it out. He's hit hard on the board by Ulanov. Barahowski knocks it down, took the stick with him. And up the center, Baumgartner shoots it from there, and he heads off as the Leafs change. They're in on the puck. Foligno trying to shake off a check. He's hit hard on that play by Ty Domi. Foligno is heading off. The Leafs fight for it on the boards and come up with it. Kessel and Berg. But now it'll be Steen slipping a pass away in front of the net. Lawler has no place to go but to shoot it down the ice. Killback icing against Winnipeg with 11:24 remaining in the third period.
Enough. Mike Foligno takes that one from Igor Ulanov. And watch the one he takes from Ty Domi right here. Foligno could still get to the bench, and he's still breathing.
Boy, these were two hard hits. Alani nearly got loose at center ice. Berg shot it ahead. It hit Dessel. Dessel can't move on it. Alani kicks it back by Osborne. And the Jets get it out. Dessel was flattened in the zone by Kennedy. 11 minutes left in the third period. Toronto 4, Winnipeg 2. Winnipeg winning their latest game in Edmonton, a big one on Thursday. Leafs defeated by Detroit last night at the Joe Louis Arena. Rouse didn't see it. Now he does, and it's passed to Berg. Berg is checked by Kennedy immediately. A pass in over the line. Ding! High shot, puck pad, block pad, covering on the angle. The Leafs pick it up back of the net. That's Rouse. He's coming out. Rouse, he's near the halfway mark of the third. Gilmore into Borshevsky, he stopped. He was flying in there, but Burns took it away from him. Here's Borshevsky, his second try. He's over the line with a shot. Blocked by Essenson. And with Gilmore standing in front of him, the goaltender from the Winnipeg Jets holds him.
Dean Kennedy got a hold of Borshevsky after he made the shot. And for the 33rd time this year, Borshevsky's helmet falls off his head. And it's a nice stop by Essenson. Now watch the shot Borshevsky takes after he took the shot from Dean Kennedy. Essenson plays most of the game about 8 feet outside his crease. And you have to have a heck of a shot to beat him from there when he's got that angle cut off. Might be better off to miss the net on him, Bob, and then have someone going for the rebound.
Great positional goaltender, though. It's solid tonight for Winnipeg. You can't knock him on the four Toronto goals. The Leafs pass it around. Comes under the stick of John Drews. He got it out. Davidoff played it in on the left wing, but they're offside. On Andrzejczuk's goal, the fourth for the Leafs tonight, Mironov and Potvin assisted. And for Felix Potvin, that was his first assist in his career.
Gilmore makes a smart little play here. Gets away with a trip and causes the offside as the Jet player John Drews' feet are over the line before the puck goes over.
His NHL career, of course. Leafs start up. Lafave finds a way to go to center before backhanding the puck in. And the Jets trying to move it up. Housley. He was forced to move it quickly as Gilmore is right in front of him. And the Leafs shoot it back into Housley. Backs up against Borshevsky. Got it up off the board to center. The Leafs are checking closely now. Andrzejczyk shot one in. And back is Lawler. Right in front of his own net. Andrzejczyk checking him. Davidov checked to center, but he shakes off that hit by Pearson. The Leafs are changing. Door the Jets. Out to center. This is McIlwain knocking it down. Putting it in by Clark. Back of the net. Ulanov. He starts the Jets away, but they can't hang on to the puck. Ellett dropping it back. 9 minutes remaining in the third period. Toronto leading 4-2. McIlwain left it there. For Gill, for Ellett. Ellett to center. He rolled it into the Winnipeg zone. And the play goes offside. McIlwain was way in there. Clark and Tkachuk starting some words now at the Winnipeg blue line.
You have to like the looks of this Tkachuk. A 20-year-old rookie who plays physically. 21 goals, 181 minutes and penalties. And doesn't take a backward step from anybody. This is Mike Eagles. There's the Keith Tkachuk, a first-round pick of the Winnipeg Jets. I think he's going to develop into one of the better all-around hockey players in this league in a short while.
This is the first meeting, Harry, of the season with these two, and they have a game coming up at Winnipeg in a couple of weeks.
They play two more games in Winnipeg before the season ends. One's a Sunday afternoon that Hockey Night Canada does later on in March. Certainly you can say this about Winnipeg. They are, have their lineup sprinkled with Europeans, but they have not taken a backward step physically against the Leafs tonight.
Alexei Zamenhof, on a quieter note. Another Winnipeg guest. He's not in the lineup tonight. He and his wife, Yelena, are proud parents of their very first child. A baby girl born last night at 10:30. So welcome to the world of Canada. Alisa, that'll be her name. 4-2, Toronto leading Winnipeg. With 8:30 remaining in the third period. A game that has had everything tonight. And likely more to come. Lots of time left for the Winnipeg Jets. There's Steen back to the goal. King is with him. Gill is there for Toronto and he clears it out. Winnipeg back to pick it up. Slapped ahead to Steen. He's stopped by Krushelnitsky. He left it near center ice. Here he got away. Collision at center. Baumgartner looking for Steen. Felix Potvin. The save on that long shot. Ripped on the glass and down the ice to relieve the pressure by Gill. That'll be icing. 7 minutes and 53 seconds remaining in the third period in a 4-2 Toronto lead.
A lot of good body check tonight thrown by both teams. Here is Kenny Baumgartner giving Thomas Steen a good shot. Thomas Steen got a point tonight to prolong his point streak to 7 games now. And in those 7, he's got 18 points. One of the more underrated hockey players in the National League, whose biggest enemy lately has been health.
Leafs control this faceoff. Orshevsky waiting for it. He just poked it out over the line. The Jets will pound it back in. Lefebvre is back there with Rauch. Here comes Barnes looking forward. But it'll be Andrzejczyk starting the play out to Gilmore. He tipped it at center ice. And down the ice it goes. Essensa has to play it. Gilmore shot it in there. Orshevsky covered by Barnes. Solani gets the pass away. But Davidov fell. And it's Orshevsky again. Davidov lifted a stick. Andrzejczyk has stopped at the Winnipeg line, and Housley is back on the ice. He's in there with Barnes, and Barnes can't handle it. Housley missed it. Near the blue line, Andrzejczyk coming out. Orshevsky up on the play. He dropped it for him. Orshevsky can't get a shot away. Again, Davidov checked him. Barnes back the other way for Winnipeg, lifting it back for Housley. He rolled it into the corner. Ellett had his man tied up. Barnes couldn't move on it. Comes to Housley. Shot it the other way to the far corner. Gill slapped it back. Housley had left to go to the Winnipeg bench. 6 minutes and 35 seconds left in the third. It is still Toronto 4, Winnipeg 2. Pearson on the ice again. Pearson back of the goal. Upended, but he gets his balance long enough to backhand it out to center ice. Chuck shot one ahead. Hill, anticipating that play, intercepted. Winnipeg Jets finding the lead, checking more closely again. Long shot, that cut bad block. That one from Drew. Drew standing in front of the net. He won't get a pass. Clark bump on this play. And there's going to be a penalty, I believe. An elbow penalty against, I think Clark is going to get the penalty. Essenza had left the Winnipeg net. It was Clark who was hit. And then I guess he came back with the elbow. And he's going.
Well, the puck was coming around the board. And Eakins, the defenseman, was pinching. And Clark saw him coming and threw the elbow at him.
All right. Clark takes the rest.
We go to Ron McLean.
Right, Bob, back to the Met Center in Bloomington, where the fans have really been going at it all night, trying to encourage Norm Green to keep the team there and not move it to Dallas. Mike Modano responds to their ovation to make it 4-2 Stars versus the Canadiens. But then Jesse Bélanger's second career goal, and it's a beauty on a 2-on-1, 4-3 now, with 2 minutes and 15 seconds to play in the third period at the Met.
Hey, Ron, thanks. He'll keep us posted, folks, on the outcome of that game. This one, 5:54 left in the third period.
Here's the penalty now, Bob. You see Eakins pinching down on Clark. Clark fends him off with an elbow and gets the penalty.
Okay, Clark cut the elbow up. He's gone. 2 minutes. Winnipeg with a great chance now on a power play. Housley and Olsson are the two defensemen. Steen is on the ice. You can bet Solani would be on here, and he is. Ethan Checkwell tonight, though. Rather quiet. One or two great bursts of speed, but not able to get through. We'll see what happens on this power play for the Jets. From the blue line, no shot from there. Housley won't shoot it. There's the drive, and that hits Shannon standing in front of the net. Gilmore fell on the puck. He holds it. There's no further play. 5:15 left in the third. 1:21 in the penalty. We're not done yet.
Well, the Leafs bench went wild as Gilmore was hooked just about the time he was going to ice it. Denny Murrell didn't call a penalty on that play, but he's called one, I think a double penalty, one to Osborne.
How's he skating over? No, he's turning back. It'll be Shannon.
Now this is a kind of a play that's a dangerous one not to call, because that would have been an easy icing for Gilmore. But it wasn't called. And in comes Osborne. So this was a friendly game for 20 minutes in the first period, but it sure hasn't been
2 minutes for roughing. Toronto penalty to number 21, Mark Osborne, 2 minutes for roughing. Time 14:45.
Here at 14:45, roughing the call on Shannon and Osborne. And the Leafs win the draw and shoot it down the ice. Clark has 1:15 left on his minor penalty. Toronto 4, Winnipeg 2. 5 minutes left in the third as the Jets come in, led by Steen. Steen with the brakes on. Coming for the net now. The pass goes in. Chuck back to the line. Olsson the other way. Housley doesn't shoot it. Quick shot by Solani. And there was Puckbank covering that short side. And the Leafs flip it down the ice. 50 seconds left of the Clark penalty. Winnipeg needing one here badly. And they come in looking for it. Solani again. Takes the pass and lost it, and Steen picked it up. Steen gets set. Housley from the blue line. He's covered. Now Steen shoots. Put by the save. And the pass all the way down the ice. As Chuck thought somebody was there at the blue line. Now he brings it in himself. To Chuck. The pass off in front of Solani. Back to Housley. Housley's shot hit near Putman, and he comes diving out. To smother it. 13 seconds left in the Wendell Clark penalty at 4:07 in the third period. Well, this show doesn't come about without some great help from people who you never see on the screen. And here are a list of some of them. And usually they make us look good, Bob, and that's not an easy assignment. And they make Kerry and McLean look good, and that's even tougher.
Well, they don't have to do much to make this game look good, because it has been from the very start. Very fast-paced first period. Dezel got the only goal in that period. And then Carlisle in the second tied it. McIlwain and Foligno made it 3-1 in the second for Toronto. Davidov early in the third. And then Andrechuk made it 4-2 Toronto with 7:13 of the third period. So the play comes up over the leaf line again. Roos can't catch up to it. Mark's penalty is over. Weak shot in, gloved by Potvin. He saw it all the way. Held it.
Call it.
3 minutes and 37 seconds left to play in the third period. This one is winding down. One, these Maple Leafs to Detroit last night at the Joe Louis Arena. Winnipeg defeated Edmonton. The Northland Coliseum on Thursday night. And in this one, as you look at other scores tonight, the Leafs are leading by two with 3:35 remaining in the third period. Winnipeg with a chance. Hot man down. And he hangs on again as John Drew, who somehow had that magic touch of scoring not too long ago, can't find it to beat Potvin. Let's check with Ronnie. 3:20 left in the third. Davidov took a hit with a high stick at center. Nothing happens though. Play goes right on. Davidov headed straight for the referee. But the play continues. Here's Pearson! In! Oh, the net was knocked off the mooring! And a penalty has been called. And Pearson had the empty net. And Mr. Morrell has a problem.
Well, it would be a penalty shot if it was in the last 2 minutes, because it's a intentional delay of the game. But because there's 3 minutes and 2 seconds to go, it will just go as an interference call. Ulanov, without any doubt, knocked the net off on purpose and gave Pearson no chance to score the goal. In the last 2 minutes of the game,
right,
that would draw a penalty shot.
62 seconds down the road, we would have seen a penalty shot. And as we were talking a little while ago, this game has had just about everything, but not that.
2 minutes for deliberately delaying the game. Time 16:58.
Delay of game, penalty, knocking the net off. But look at Pearson, Harry. He waited patiently for this chance.
And here he has it right here. The goalie down, nobody around, and Ulanov takes the chance away. A pretty good trade-off probably for 2 minutes. Wendell Clark ran into Stu Barnes, and then he gave a little tap to Davidov, who moaned and groaned, but to no avail, according to Denny Morrell.
Ulanov in the penalty box. Deliberately delaying the hockey game at 16:58. And the Toronto power play in operation again. Fruitless tonight in three previous power plays. 3:02 left. Third period. Toronto 4. Winnipeg 2. Gilmore. Andrechuk. Borshevsky. Kellen. Gill. Gill takes the puck to the blue line. The pass goes to the right side, into the corner, back out to Gilmore. Gilmore winds up, takes a shot. Gill will give it to him again. There's the shot, rebound! Down goes Essence, the puck back to Gilmore, to Gill. Way outside at the blue line. Now Gilmore, sharp angle, won't shoot it. Gill again, this way for Ellis, to Gill. Shot, blocked. Gilmore! Knocked down by Essence. Horsfatto was hurt stopping the shot from Gill at the blue line. And he's limping off. 2:15 remaining in the third period. 1:15. Power play for Toronto. Andrechuk picked it loose for Dave Ellis. Ellis on the boards.
fired a pass in. It hit Gilmore and it went out the other way. Eagles shoving ahead. Trelawney on the fly. He's in there. A big move to stop. But Ellis caught up to him and held him off.
And then what a burst of speed by Trelawney. Gilmore tipped it in. 1:50 remaining in the third period. 48 seconds on this lead power play. The puck is over the glass into the crowd with 1:46 remaining.
Well, the Leafs get a day off, and then they, for 2 days off, and then they head to Washington Tuesday night, and back here against the Hartford Whalers on Wednesday, and against Tampa on Friday, and then they're gone on a little road trip. The Winnipeg Jets play tomorrow night in Buffalo. And the races continue, Bob, but they're down into the teens with reference to games remaining. The trading deadline coming up in 2 weeks. All kinds of noise in all kinds of cities about teams that are trying to make a move to improve their chances of advancing in the playoffs. With as many teams as out of the playoffs by now, you may see those lower teams trade for the future.
Winnipeg wanting to win this one to move up on L.A. Coming into the game, 1 point behind Los Angeles. Toronto trying to get back into a tie with Detroit again. Or second in the Norris Division. Losing to Detroit last night. This is Pilani, but he missed on that by a couple of feet. 1:25 remaining in the third period. The Leafs remain on this power play for another 20 seconds. And the play is stopped as Eagles fell on the puck. Kennedy. And that stopped the play.
Well, the Molson Cup three stars, not as easy as some nights to pick them. Toronto defensively has played very strongly, so I think Bob Rouse and two or three of his defense partners would probably get some consideration. Felix Potvin has been sharp. Contrary to last night for the Leafs, when there was no chance of picking anybody but Potvin. A tough decision tonight. The Winnipeg Jets offensively have never really got it going. A lot better in the third than the first two, but not as strong offensively as you thought he might be.
The Winnipeg Jets starting back out. Shot goes into the corner from Shannon. Trelawney in to dig it out. Trelawney kicked it loose for Housley. We're in the final minute now. Penalty is over. Winnipeg at full strength. Essence going to the bench, looking for the extra man and maybe a couple of goals. Here's Trelawney. Gets his shot away, but it hit a skate. He had his stick tied up on the first attempt. Pearson lifted a high one down the ice. Lawler back. Clark stopped him. Clark nearly got a shot at the empty net. Pearson ran into his man and hit him hard. Wait at the Winnipeg bench.
Morrell's going to give Pearson an elbowing or a charging penalty. The Jets took the goalie out while the play was on, and it's the job of the man that replaces the goalie to yell that the goalie's out, because three or four of the Winnipeg players, especially the forwards, might not have been able to see Essence come out of the net while the play's on. Oh, Clark's going to get it. I thought Pearson would get it for running over Shannon. Here it is right here. Whoa. No doubt about that one. Lawler hangs in there to bump the puck out of the zone. You got to give him credit for that. Winnipeg's going to take a timeout. 32 seconds to go. Bob Rouse played a strong game. And here's an example right here as he ties up the most dangerous Winnipeg forward, Timo Solani, and prevents him from getting a pretty good shot on goal from close range on Putman.
That was a very big defensive play by the Leafs defenseman. Solani did have an opportunity, so he saw it, but his stick was tied up. And then he did get a shot away as he shook it off, and it hit a skate in front of Putman. But he really has been silent tonight. He made two or three sensational rushes with great speed.
Why Winnipeg has come here in this table salon.
The one thing about Winnipeg that I've been impressed with, that I wondered how they would stand up to a team. Toronto's a pretty aggressive team. Winnipeg has not taken a backward step in that department tonight. They just couldn't get their offense going like it often has this year.
Essence is back in the net, but he'll soon leave. There he goes now. As Housley gets center ice and shoots it in. 23 seconds remaining. Winnipeg, they won't give up. They're down two goals. In back of the net is centered. Here's a shot. That one off a stick and went high with 10 seconds remaining. And the Leafs leading 4-2. And this clearing play by Osborne will sew it up. Game over. And the Leafs win 4-2.
Well, a top performance by the Leafs as far as effort's concerned. This is the third game in four nights, as I mentioned. They got badly beaten last night, and as Pat Burns predicted, they came out with a good, solid, energetic effort tonight.
The final shots are 28-26 in favor of Toronto. They defeat the Winnipeg Jets tonight, 4-2. Just a moment, our Molson Cup three-star selection.
Last year, with your assist.
Selected by Hockey Night in Canada. The first star, Felix Platzan. The second star, Bob Rouse. And the third star, Thomas Steen.
Toronto Maple Leafs win without John Cullen, without Glenn Anderson, and without Jamie McCallum on the second game of back-to-back games, and as Harry mentioned, the third in four nights. 77 points, they're tied with Detroit, second in the Norris Division, and stretch their home unbeaten streak to seven games. A big victory for Pat Burns and the Maple Leafs. You'll hear from Bob Rouse in just a moment. The Winnipeg Jets now move on to Buffalo, and hopefully won't have to battle the bad roads that everybody else in the vicinity has, while the Leafs will move to Washington Tuesday and then return home for a game against Hartford on Wednesday. To recap the Molson Cup three stars tonight, Felix Potvin, number one, Bob Rouse, number two, and Thomas Steen, the third star. The Toronto Maple Leafs double the Jets in the first of three meetings. They'll meet twice in Winnipeg later in the year. Stay tuned for more on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. This is a heartbreaker today in Boston, so they are 9 points behind Toronto. Number two star in this evening's game. And it was a physical affair. There's no doubt about that. All night long, body checks all over the place. And Bob joins me now. Your thoughts on the game?
Yeah, it seemed like a division game, a Norris division. Winnipeg really came out and played a strong game. It was a hard-hitting game, for sure.
And your mom was here when you came in. I says, now, we did a little dinner together on Monday. I said, I didn't pick the stars. Harry Neal and Bob Cole were involved in the selection, but your mom will be pleased.
Yeah, I thought she was in charge of picking the stars tonight. I don't get too many of those, so it was a great honor.
How long will she stay in town?
She's only here for a few more days. We had a new baby, so she's here visiting and trying to help out.
Oh, well, congratulations. Tell me about the baby.
It's a little girl, Callie Nicole, so we're all happy and proud. We've got another son, so it's going good.
Don Cherry says, this poor guy, it's amazing you play so well. You played a lot of the year with Dmitry Mironov, not so much tonight, but Dmitry speaks Russian and Felix Potvin speaks French. He says, I don't know how the guy's still a star here this evening, but what's going with the Leafs so defensively well?
Yeah, it's going well defensively. Pat Burns is a really stressed defense, and the guys are believing it. The forwards are doing a great job coming back and believing in the system. We're getting some real key goaltending there. We kind of let up last night in Detroit, as you all know, but we bounced back tonight, and it was a good effort.
You certainly did. Congratulations on being the number two star tonight, Bob. You deserved it, and good luck in Washington and back here Wednesday against Hartford.
Thank you very much, Ron.
Bob Rouse, the number two star for the Toronto Maple Leafs, says they win by a pair.
The announcement that the team was moving to Big D have gone.